The following episode of Mystery Titans Theater was made possible from a generous contribution from Wrestle 40 and from viewers like you.
Well, it's a hot one,
and it's Mystery Titans Theater. My name is Travis Walsh, and we are thrilled to be back in, looking back in July of 1982, and I'm here, as always, with my good pal, Johnny Hedgepeth. Johnny, how you doing, pal?
Tired, but here.
Well, yeah, but we're going to have a good time, because we also got the Ken Burns of Wrestling, the Chief J Historian, Kelly Nails home.
Hey, y'all.
Hi.
And finishing off the Frightful Four, that's right, we're back. Our good pal, the great James Hamilton. James, how are you?
Hot. I'm hot.
Yep, it's a hot, I said. And here we go. Walking right into our boy Dusty here. That's exciting.
Two legends to kick it off.
Yes, this is Wrestle 40. This is the same day that we watched last episode.
Yeah, I didn't even know what we were watching tonight. I was assuming a tribute to Vincent Kennedy McMahon of some sort, you know, since he's retired, in a care home or something like that.
I read someone posted, he's like, just picturing Vince sitting in his mansion calling DoorDash, getting frustrated, because nobody knows what a steak wrap is.
Oh, God.
All right, so he's talking about Morocco right now. That's who he's talking about this time.
Mm-hmm, yeah.
Pretty awesome.
This is coming up on around the time where Piper turns babyface against Morocco.
The guy who ghosted me.
We can trash his ass, a lazy beach bum ass tonight.
Got his Fred Berry rerun hat on here.
Do that, Dad.
Looking good, though. Yeah. Oh, yeah, so this is what, July 3rd, 1982? Yeah. The very next day, July 4th, 1982, at the Omni in Atlanta was the big supercard where you had Ric Flair versus Bob Backlund title versus title.
Wow. Yeah, well, we just saw, we watched a little bit of New York from around this time, too, but that would have been right, I think it was a little later.
Yeah, and there's no footage of that show, unfortunately.
Really?
No. Well, it may be actually in the WWE vault, since they seem to have a bunch of Georgia shows from this time, but who knows when they'll ever dip into that again.
They do have a few promos. There's a promo from it.
Yeah, and Backlund buried it as not a very good match in his book.
I'm going to. He's going to strangle her. He's going to strangle her. He's going to strangle her.
I'm in love, Florent.
I remember this.
I'm going to be forever.
£1 a day.
Look at this. Look at
my healthy diet.
Oh, my. These are bringing back memories.
Ah! Hey!
It's a boss hog.
I'm Ann Murray.
$1?
Only 45 cents.
Oh, wow.
What a steal.
Is it Frankie
Valli? Getting full.
Oh, we get the commercials. That's the best part.
Yep.
Nice.
Not sold in stores.
Priceless recordings.
This would be a pretty good collection, actually.
I'd get this.
Mm-hmm. Love Frankie Valli.
I'm saying Frankie and the season we're into.
All the hits are
golden here. Treasuries.
All 14 hits.
Don't think twice. It's all right. Wait a second.
Gary. Oh, my goodness.
He was good, man. He did Grease in the late 70s. Like, he spanned the decades.
How many Stone Cold classics from Frankie Valli in the season? Four? Did you say out of that list? Like, four?
Dude, they got like
at least seven.
12.
Well, I wouldn't say
there's enough for a Broadway musical.
Yeah, a Broadway musical with all those songs.
What's it called?
Jersey Boys.
Yeah. Jersey Boys. Yeah.
It's really good. I've seen it. 800-232-6966.
Why is it with this show we always wind up talking about Broadway at some point?
Because I'm here.
Calling on name!
Speaking of which, oh my God, my daughter had a That's four seasons. Just finished a musical theater camp this week. Performances. It was pretty great. It was pretty great. I mean, let me tell you.
What show did she do?
When it started, the first thing it opened, I'm like, $450. But then, like, they really backload. Like, they kind of got the everybody's worst number out of the way first.
Sure. Then they bowed it. They ran and clean up. Yeah.
Fantastic. Yeah. Bat and clean up.
I'm loving that Sonny King is going. Sonny King's going for a King. Yeah, he's going for a black Kojak thing.
Yeah. Yeah. I like it.
It's a rare Sonny King sighting. There's not a ton of footage of him out there that I'm aware of.
What a presence, man. I've never seen
I don't think I've ever seen a first promo.
The Memphis set, one of the first matches on there is a very young Ricky Morton versus Sonny King.
That's right, yeah. I believe maybe even the first match. Ring in Georgia. It's a low to the ground. When the Samoans are in the territory.
Yeah. Oh, they're talking about it. They just mentioned Backlund.
Yeah.
And Ivan Putski, I guess maybe more than Backlund went down there.
Yeah, they sent a few other guys. I'll get the card up on my phone here. I'm curious to see.
The Ric Flair roast happening right now.
Yeah, God, that's a disaster.
Oh, really? I saw one good line. Something about the crowd being so white, it's about to storm the Capitol with Jericho.
Oh, was that from there?
Was Jericho there?
I don't know if Jericho was there, but that's pretty
good. I don't think so. Taken the
very best that Jackson had. We were talking about last week with Steve, the best man. But we were talking about, did you hear Jericho and Ventura in that one clip, James?
No.
Where he just basically says, if I was there, I would have shot your old lady between the eyes. Basically, is what he said.
He was on Jericho's podcast. He started going on about January 6th. He's like, if I'd been one of the security guards, I just got to see they might not be breathing, Chris. and Jericho is just very
you understand what I'm saying?
I murder your wife, Chris, because I'm a frog man. That's Mike Jackson. That's Mike Jackson in there. He's still wrestling.
Is he?
Oh yeah, Mike Jackson is like almost. He's in his 70s, and he's still actively wrestling in Southern Indies.
Crazy. One of the greatest jobbers of all time.
Mm-hmm.
Where is this card? I can't find it.
Back up into the far turnbuckle. I have a, you know. Like, currently, I've been getting into, like oh, I got the GCW pay-per-view a few months ago, you know? I'm like, I can afford to get this. I'm morbidly interested in Flair's last match thing. I'm not going to get it, but I'm like, do I want to see Ric Flair maybe die in the ring? Because that's the selling point, right? That he might actually die in the ring.
High possibility.
Probably. Sort of low-key wanting it to happen himself.
Well, I'm sure somebody's taking numbers on it. Like, I'm sure there's, like, something on it.
It'll be all smoke and mirrors. It's not going to be anything. So I got the card for the next day at the Omni. And Van Putski was in the curtain jerker teaming with Tom Pritchard, who was subbing for Tommy Rich. So Rich no-showed. Wow. Again, Stan Hansen and Ole Anderson, NWA Tag Team Champions at the time. Kevin Sullivan defeated Mr. Saito at 7:02. Michael Hayes and Terry Gordy, who were in the territory at the time, took on the Wild Samoans. Ooh, that's a kind of a dream match. Mass Superstar pin Mr. Wrestling 2. Oh, here's an interesting result. Don Morocco pinned Dusty Rhodes at the 49-second mark. And Piper was with Don Morocco, so maybe Piper interfered or something. Wow. Super Destroy defeated Tom Pritchard. Pritchard worked double duty. Leroy Brown defeated Big John Studden at Texas Deathmatch.
Oh boy, I'm sure that was a classic. Oh boy.
Why is there a bear hug in a Texas Deathmatch?
Yeah, I know. last bear hug wins or loses. Paul Orndorff defeated Jimmy Snuka by disqualification. That could have been a good match. And then, in the main event, Backlund and Flair went to a double countout.
That sounds like a pretty great card, to be honest.
Yeah, I don't have an attendance number for it either.
Look at that deep V. Look at that deep V on Mr. Wrestling, too.
Here's the man. Stud. Beautiful. Nothing like a masked wrestler in a sharp collared shirt. A la the spoiler.
He could be a mayor in Mexico with that outfit.
You're going to see if you've got the guts or the power you talk about many times.
A mental. But he's a two left winger for me.
Well, let me tell you something. You're going to have a mental problem. Why is Italian voice?
Italian Mexican. Of course, an important night for
you. You know, 4th of July, it's party time. Can you believe that I'm a hey, can you believe that currently I'm a sex symbol in wrestling?
And I'm going to get so wasted tonight, I'm not going to make it to the show tomorrow, Gordon. You don't have to
worry about it. That's right. Remember that when that kid dressed like Owen Hart for that DX spot?
There he is.
Looks like, do you remember that?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
I do.
Jason Sensation.
Jason Sensation.
He's from Winnipeg.
All right, I'll give him a shot. See what they got left in
I remember in Backlund's book, he was down there. He just had a sense that something shady was going on. Yeah, like they might try to fuck him. Yeah. And he gets on the phone with Vince Sr. Shit gets worked on a payphone. And shit apparently gets worked out. And like Ric Flair comes up and approaches him. And it's just kind of like, hey, I just want to let you know everything's going to be fine. Da, 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 da. Yeah. Clearly nervous because Bob Backlund, if it turned into any kind of a shoot, Bob Backlund would have murdered him.
Yeah, yeah. Flair is not shooting.
What was the time on the, do you have a time on the Texas death match?
No times. Hopefully.
Oh, so this is what's happening tomorrow.
Okay, this is the day before. The tickets were still available.
Yeah. Yeah, no, it wasn't a sellout. And in those days, there was always huge walk-ups.
Oh, yes, Freebirds, of course.
Here we go.
Boo! National Tag Team Champions.
Crank it, man.
They'd already
crank the Skinner, man. Fucking crank your Skinner.
Skinner, man. Feuded and reunited by this point in Georgia. And they're not with Buddy Jack at this point.
Last night was our first shot for the title, so hey, what can you expect? I mean, you know, it's just like that. Now, don't get me wrong, Gordon. We like to give credit
work
credit.
Oh, check out that fringe.
Yeah. Pretty great. Like Orville Peck. You guys know Orville Peck?
No.
Country singer. He's awesome. You should look him up. He's got a great gimmick. Really, really good. Really kind of old school.
Routed commuter trains. Oh, here we go. Rush hour buses, overpacked
closets. They all. Oh, I remember this. Wrinkled sleeves,
crushed trousers. Is this the?
Introducing
Steam Away. Yeah.
Steam Away. Miraculous steamer, presser, cleaner you use at home, at school, while traveling to press the. This commercial was on during Gilligan's Island. As steam this gets commercial. Out, special brush
goes to work to clean dust and lint right now, just like a professional dry cleaner, and so safe.
Now, what if you were wearing that sweater?
Iron's like a sucker.
$100 dress.
Oh, no.
Get away, you dumb shit.
Kind of seemed like she did that on purpose. Dress coats to look
like new. What's the matter with you? Freshen blouses. Clean ties, wrinkle-free.
Look, it's Saturday morning. This loser on the left.
This wrinkly loser. Just needs pressing
to look new and fresh again. Dry clean. Just the dry cleaner cost. A
whopping $27.50. Oh my God. James, you fucking idiot.
And
she'll not only save money,
she'll have delightfully. And what does this cost? Just
$9.99. Three easy payments.
$27.50.
I remember when I was a kid, and I worked
right next to my pornography. I'm so high. I'm steaming away the age.
Steaming a plant. Steaming a face.
Style there, the internet.
Hey, $18. That's a bargain.
That's kind of whispering.
What's the number? What's the number?
Man, yo. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Why does New Jersey always have a different number, Johnny? Any Any reason for that?
Is it, I'm sure it's like an offer varies kind of thing.
I'm sure it's mob related.
Yeah, or union.
It has to go through a very certain warehouse.
Okay, it was one of them. We got our own number. That's fine.
Just call the number. You know the number.
Is our Orndorff is here? This is
Mr. Wonderful.
See some OP.
You dance with OP.
So in this era, people must not. In this era, people must not go over the top rope so often.
No, it's a DQ.
Post office. Maybe that's why he changed it. Somebody's bugging him about it.
Not a post office!
Stop trying to put your mail in me!
Come on, eat it.
Just teabagging him.
Jesus
Christ. Oh, no.
I saw that Steam Away commercial.
Away.
Everybody would like to take a shot at you and see if they can establish a reputation by facing you.
It's got me in the Steam Away.
Oof!
That sponsorship.
Orndorff's
got sponsorship from the
Steam amateur away. Wrestling Orndorff here.
Yeah.
Trying to get Styles over on his back. 1980s wrestling must have just been rife with pink eye. Everybody just must have had pink eye all the time.
Mm.
Staph infections.
Yeah.
Those dirty mats.
And interestingly enough, the former national heavyweight champion.
Here, someone's showing up.
Mm-hmm.
Buzz Sawyer. There he is.
Jesus. Watching this match. Ticking time bomb.
On the long list of my favorite professional wrestlers who are total pieces of shit, Buzz Sawyer is on the top of the list. He's awesome.
Is he up for like Dark Side of Wrestling bad or?
I'm sure they could get something out of it.
Yeah, he died super young.
He had a reputation for like, hey, I'll train you, give me all your money, and then skipping down.
With Undertaker.
He did it with Undertaker, yeah.
Total scumbag. Screwed over Bret Hart early in his career in Georgia, actually.
He also had the coolest boots ever in wrestling, those dog boots.
They were made from real dogs.
That's why he's going to get on Dark Side of the Ring. He's the Cruella DeVille of wrestling.
Like my loafers, former gophers.
He insisted they had to be baby beagles. My brother was always saying that the softest jacket you could ever make could be made entirely out of kitten paws.
Yeah.
Imagine a kitten paw jacket.
That's probably true.
Just hundreds and hundreds of kittens.
Kitten paws! Just
walking around in stumps.
Dude, the person in the factory having to remove the claws, though, that's tedious work.
I'm thinking of boycotting them, though.
Somehow cauterizing.
They don't treat
the
workers who take the paws off the kittens really well.
Reverse Nelson on. Chucking them like clams. One shoulder is off.
Scrappy McGowan checking Tom Petty is your referee for this match, apparently.
Scrappy McGowan.
Hey.
He and Tommy Rich go to the same barber. I'd like the Cousin Oliver.
Everybody. Man, this is
a really grinding. Surprised he's not wearing a singlet.
I've never seen Orndorff do this kind of shit before. I mean, I think probably seen why.
I think Orndorff's the baby face because he and Snuka were a tag team, and now they're feuding, and Snuka was definitely the heel.
I'm not sure.
Allegedly.
Who's the guy in red? Just a guy?
Just a man.
Just a man.
A mighty man is he.
No, I think we're going to get the Flair back when Duel
interview. You're singing some Jesus Christ Superstar there,
that's
Val?
Right, that's right.
Yeah, he is. That's a great karaoke song at the bar. The song about Jesus.
Yeah. Oh, dude, I think I've told you before when we walked into somebody singing, "Get out, King of the Jews." I told you that before. He had a very effeminate voice. And he was singing that song at the top of his lungs. Imagine walking into a karaoke bar. Had, dreams about making a reputation for himself.
He is going to have to move a lot more efficiently than he is right now. He's got a handful of problems.
Scrappy McGowan looks like the road manager of the Marshall Tucker Band or something.
Wow. That was a no frills win.
I know, and it's like one wrestling move. There was one wrestling move with the suplex.
I kind of liked it.
Yeah, I know. Like it was different gritty that we see from old.
Definitely because he's a baby face.
I guess so.
That's, to show that he can wrestle.
P.O. should get involved in a feud with Special Delivery. Jones. Must see who gets there fastest. Rod Piper has been suspended.
At this time, it's a run-in by UPS Jackson. As I get more details, I was
just given that information and nothing further. So Rod Piper has been suspended.
Yeah.
Yes.
I wonder if he still makes his way in. Oh, wow.
There we go.
The man of the hour.
Like, I want, somebody said... Somebody else tweeted today about that. I really want him to just, after one lighthearted joke, break a beer bottle and start to stab
someone. Just start stabbing him.
What, the very first lighthearted joke?
And Bob Backlund, of course, is from Minnesota. Bill Gordon, in 40 years, I'm going to die in the ring. All around the wrestling world, I've been waiting to see. My son-in-law is going to literally book me to death.
Serious.
There it is. That's
Bobby
talking.
Just walked in. Apartments. Sorry, I'm late. The uncharacteristic of me.
Saturday Night Fever, Backlund.
Yeah. Sorry, traffic. I had a haircut.
This is the last time that two champs faced each other, too. In a day or so, we'll find out. During the glory days, anyway. This is a matter of paramount
importance, I think, to wrestling fans the world over. A confrontation, first time ever. I know I have a bit of facial recognition of your championship issues, qualities, but Bob Backlund looks like William H. Macy to me.
Jacked William H. Macy.
Yeah.
Yeah. Look at his neck.
Like milk fed William H. Macy.
Unbelievably strong individual. A lot of hard work and a lot of determination. And I know
I respect my opponent very, very much. He works very hard at what he does. Oh, geez. He's got the NWA title. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Okay. Oh, geez. Yeah.
In my spare time, I'm an auctioneer down at the youth center. I auction off many things. Going once, going twice, three times sold. I'm looking forward to
getting into the ring. $1, $1. Do I hear $1, $1, $1?
Lady in the hat, give 7-7. I'm here 7. But besides the champion of football,
the World Series in baseball, just about every sport. What a contrast.
Singing in the background. And I think this is the right thing to
happen in professional wrestling. Boring! In the middle of that ring. Well, it's like he said. So I've been watching modern WWE lately. Is there anything I can do as a viewer to make people say, stop saying what?
Yeah, I don't know.
Is there anything I can do?
Well, that's the funniest thing. That had disappeared for a long time, and for some reason, it's back. It's weird.
Nostalgia.
It died out. The what's died out a while ago, and for some reason, they're back. I work hard at what I do. I spend a lot of time in the gym. I do a lot of traveling, and I don't like. I travel door to door. I travel door to door to tell everyone about the good word of our Lord Jesus Christ. When we ring,
I'm gonna forget about all that. Throw the mist, majestic collar. When that bell rings, it's gonna be out there to win. Well, thank you so very much. Oh, I think some
very extremely heavy comments from both champions. And I am drunker than I've ever been before. Confrontation
of two of the greatest champions, I think. There's a flask in my mic.
This was like 9-10 o'clock in the morning too. They always taped early on a Saturday.
Have you guys ever seen Brockmire?
He's hammered by that time.
Oh yeah.
Have you seen Brockmire?
Oh,
yeah.
Is that a third hand gonna punch you in the middle?
Yeah. Oh, I know this ad. This is Ginsu. Yeah. Introducing Ginsu. Cut me a sandwich. Cut me a sandwich with that foot. This Ginsu chef's knife.
It's the cut my tin cut a tin can with it. But why would you want to?
Look at that. Branch
and still remain well, look at that. Right through a pine tree.
Hey, when you hey, look, tomato. I want a BLT, a branch lettuce, a branch lettuce and tomato sandwich.
Sticks in my tomato.
Unfortunately, when you own a Ginsu, you have to make that noise every time you cut something.
God damn it. If I had a nickel every time I saw this ad as a kid, I'd have a lot of fucking nickels. This is just, I remember every detail of this.
All right, who wants cake?
Look at this.
Oh, he's so violent after he's cut. Ew, gross.
Oh, classic.
Who wants some, who wants some pipe and
classic ham
nickels
with pineapple
soup? You'll always have one handy. Plus, you get. I love that the chef is the karate guy. It's the best.
It's so tough. All right, what's he going to slice now? No, I don't need any fruit salad. Like thank you.
The nail and pineapple.
The nail is what gives it
the inside of my throat.
The nail is what gives it its flavor.
It slices pizza. Wow.
Okay. Watch me slice this pizza like a hot knife through butter.
I have a question. Can a Ginsu cut another Ginsu knife?
That's the answer to the
question. Find out.
Here's how to order. Watch us, try it
really?
Out on this.
You get 15 knives for $19?
Yeah, it's bargain.
Travis, call.
Shipping and handling only $2.
I'm going to try the jersey.
Yeah.
Wow, that guy was a real asshole.
We don't use ones in New Jersey.
As I said, of course, Christ, we're going can to you believe those fucking knives?
Sharp
here
today on Championship Wrestling, and in a moment we're going to be seeing sharp knife.
Pardon me, the magnificent Morocco in action.
There he is.
There he is.
Teeny wangers, man. However,
there are forces against you
now, including the police. Teaming with Ole, I never do that.
Oh, they were longtime partners.
Pretty much just in Georgia, I think. Where's Tommy Rich got this guy? Where is he hiding? The Polish strongman, Ivan Putski, is coming.
I listened to you talk about it at the top of the show. I listened to Tommy Rich talk about it. Everybody. I've had bad dreams about that Stan Hansen lariat. I swear to you, I sent Travis a note about that one time.
Yes.
Literally a nightmare. Scared of Hanson and
Anderson. You know, I get it. He's scary, dude. Smart
to be terrifying.
Yeah, one of the all-time great. The fuck?
Here we go.
The hell's
there's a, what a team. That's Morocco.
Sorry.
There's a trio.
This is the first time he's ever tried cocaine.
We're all excited.
Yeah, he wasn't even supposed to come out for this promo. Tommy Rich goes, "Hey man, try some of this shit."
Oh.
And he leaves.
Weed isn't smoking on the beach in Hawaii. He's got something to say. He says it, and whoever the big white shark is, I guess that must be a Dusty Rhodes or somebody. What if the football team represented there? Any idea?
I can't see.
Yeah, it's too blurry. Well, we're going to find
out, I'm sure, before the day is out. And Don Morocco just learned about a key bump. Morocco is in the ring at this time. He's going up against Carl
Vizi. One fall, 10-minute time limit. Oh, Morocco.
This guy's going to get mauled to death.
Oof, that's rough. Rough.
Who is it?
Do you know Carl Beasy.
Carl Beasy?
And that's his professional name. I don't even know what it is.
Looks like Eugene. Looks like Eugene.
Say, he does look like Eugene, yeah. And Morocco totally dominating this man.
Beasy has had absolutely no opportunity whatsoever. As fucked up as the Eugene character was.
Yeah, I loved it. Always loved it.
I know there's certain terrible things I love. It was the fact that he was with William Regal.
Yeah.
Especially when Bischoff first introduces him to Regal, he's like, "What? He's a window licker."
I love that he did everybody else's patented.
That he, I love that he was a savant. You know that he was like he was the Rain Man of wrestling.
He was a wrestling savant. Yeah.
And it led to my favorite baby face turn maybe of all time is when Triple H is in the ring yelling for Eugene because Eugene had been let into the building and ruined his match the week before. He's going fucking crazy. And Regal comes out and cuts the like one of the greatest promos of all time. He's like, if you had done that to anyone else, I would have applauded your cunning, but not to that young innocent boy, to lead him like a lamb to slaughter. You have made an enemy of me. It's like, okay, I get the goosebumps thinking about it. He's like, villains like us, all that shit. Oh, it's so good.
Oh, that's wonderful.
Yeah, it's on YouTube. And then in the match, of course, Triple H, you know, bloodies him and he's on a stretcher and he fucks him up. Because Eugene is the who the match was was intended for. And I was like, oh, fuck, I just want, give me Regal.
Right.
But it's one of the great promos. You can hear the crowd. He's one of my favorite things on AEW. I look forward to seeing anyone in Blackpool Combat Club on AEW because I know Regal's going to be on commentary.
Right.
He said something last night. He's like, I'm happier than a dog with two willies.
That's pretty happy.
Yeah, I heard the last Dynamite was really good.
I didn't finish it, but yeah, the entire Ricky Starks, Danhausen, into Hook getting the belt, to a Ricky Starks baby face turn, to a Hobbs heel turn. It was just, it was amazing. It felt like watching Mid-South. Go watch it.
That's what people were saying.
So good.
Memphis.
Marty, 2K22, our first person in the chat today. First time.
Hey!
His first, our first message here is literally butt-humping him.
Literally what?
Butt-humping him.
What we were seeing in the ring. Look like that's what.
Oh, the.
That's right. What Gorilla Monsoon would say. He's literally butt humping him, Jazz.
His rear anal protuberance.
Yeah, well, we're gonna get his
version
of the pile driver. Yeah.
Boom.
Awkward.
Awkward.
That kicked out of 3.1.
Pile driver.
Kind of looks like Paul Williams reffing there, Johnny.
Yes.
How are you, my friend? How's your neck? Is your neck okay?
Are you okay, friend?
Why are you filming?
Next on our agenda.
Wrestlers with broken necks. Oh, fuck you, Sensei.
There we go.
Yeah.
Pitching for the Reds at that time.
Who's your favorite pitcher this
was
this era?
Big year for the Braves. They won the NL East. Though, yeah.
83, 84. Who's your favorite pitcher?
83. No, this
is
82.
Is
82? Oh. Mine was
Joe Torre. Holy shit.
No. He was the manager of the Braves.
Have you seen my family? I am. He's going to do Mel Gibson in Payback and that Ransom movie.
I have a very specific
Steve
set of skills.
Steve Carlson for 1982, James.
Steve Carlson? I was an Eckers League guy.
Lefty for the Phillies. He was pretty awesome.
Well, I was a Phillies fan in 82.
Watching baseball at the time, but...
I know, 82, I had gotten mad because the Phillies traded Greg Luzinski, so I'd sworn off baseball for
done.
A couple of years. Yeah.
They would bounce back and win the pennant the next year, though, 83. With the Wheeze Kids.
I played baseball when I was a kid, and somebody told me I played like Dennis Eckersley, so I did my research.
Okay, you got
and
you became
he,
an alcoholic. And,
oh yeah, no, I'm halfway there. Like I'm doing pretty well. Kenny Rogers. No, but he was a great pitcher, and I love that he used to be through his eyelids, and he had that crazy side. Elbow thing. Right hand.
Oh, yeah.
Well, here we go. Yeah, but you could do tobacco commercials.
Tobacco
on TV.
Ads. Wow, crazy. Not too sweet.
Oh, wow.
You notice they don't show him spitting.
Yeah. Oh, it's because I don't know. Does it look like either one of these fellows spits?
That guy looks like Michael Madsen.
Or.
I just swallowed this.
No. Oh, yeah. Wow. Is it okay to swallow? Pretty.
Why do you think we're on this trip together, brother?
Great time to do.
That's the plan.
Chana, the wild rapids.
You're doing some chana going down the rapids.
Bad idea.
Who the fuck thought chewing tobacco and Whitewater Rapids was a good idea? Good combination. I've never been so sick.
Oh, my tummy.
Fighting for my life.
My tummy.
broke, just barely on the count.
He's got a real Prince Valiant looking thing.
Who's in the singlet? Yeah, who's the...
Oh, no, just...
The enhancement talent? I'm not sure.
The Donna's father from that 70s show, based by the hair. Oh, yeah.
Well, I was going to say, seeing as we were talking about Jesus Christ Superstar, Josh Mostel is in the ring. The original Herod.
Yeah. He does look like an actor from the late 70s, early 80s.
Good arm drag take.
Judd Hirsch with the mustache. Tommy Rich.
Oh, he's got a mustache? Oh, I can't even tell.
No, this guy was every out-of-town gangster who double-crosses Boss Hogg on every other episode of the Dukes of Hazzard. Yeah, we'll frame those Duke voice for you.
They really were pretty forgiving.
I have no idea who. So who is this? Is Edgar Winters? Is who's the blonde guy?
Tommy Rich.
Gene Hackman.
Tommy
Rich. Wildfire.
Tommy Rich.
Popeye.
And Gene Hackman.
Yeah, at this time, Rich was at the peak of his popularity, pretty much.
Tommy Rich was one of those wrestlers that I knew was great and famous just because of magazines, but he never, in all the wrestling that I had to watch, wasn't in any of it. I think he was in Memphis by that time.
Yeah, I didn't get to see him until he was old and working heel, mostly.
Yeah. It wasn't until he came back as a jobber to the stars guy in our York Foundation.
Yeah.
Thomas Rich.
How many wrestling buddies were released, Marty's asking.
I have no idea.
Probably about 10 official.
How many
wrestling
what?
Remember wrestling?
There was Hogan, there was Savage, there was Jake Roberts, there was the Road Warriors.
The Barber.
Boss Barber. Man, maybe. I believe.
There was Big Boss Man.
Yeah, it had to be Boss Man, yeah. Ted DiBiase. There was a million.
Ted DiBiase. There was a Ted DiBiase.
In the green.
Hillbilly Jim?
No.
No?
I think that would have been
no.
There, yeah.
And then, it, like 10 years ago, but you know, like, yeah, maybe close to 10 years ago, they released modern ones because I got my nephew when he was like 4 or 5. I got him Rey Mysterio. And they had Cena.
Oh, they had a Jake the Snake one because they showed it on that show.
Yeah.
Is it life size?
Yeah, because that's what you want to cuddle with is Jake Roberts as a little kid with your stuffed Jake Roberts.
It's the only one that when you hug it, it groans.
Yeah. When you rip it open, instead of foam, it's cigarette butts.
There was WCW buddies too. I came across a Sting one, like a dirty old Sting one in a Vancouver.
But that's the way they actually sold it.
Yeah, that was
covered in filth.
No, it looked
your
like
Sting
yeah,
is way too clean.
Then left out in the
put that
rain.
On the shelf.
You said you send in $9.99 and 3 proof of purchases, and you'll get dirty old Sting.
Dirty Sting.
Dirty old Sting.
5 o'clock shadow.
It's just a kid playing with it and going, ew.
Down on his luck, Sting. Great Depression era Sting.
Johnny's buddy, Buck Zumoff, really tried to sell wet wrestling buddies, I heard.
Yeah, that's what, you know what? That's what I want. I want someone to make me a custom-made Rock and Roll Buck Zumoff wrestling buddy. Okay, that's what I want. I'll put it on the wall.
I would like a Moose Cholak.
Ghetto Blaster.
Oh,
give me a Moose Cholak.
I don't want to slip that.
Moose Cholak.
Giving away something that's coming later tonight, buddy.
I know Christmas is coming, but
are you implying that Rock and Roll Buck Zumoff is returning to the show?
God, Zumoff. But our boy.
Oh no way!
Oh Moose!
No.
Nice.
Way. And someday we're going to see Black Cats again.
I think he only wrestled that one match.
I just know it.
Rich is making this kind of even for some reason.
Yeah.
Martin.
Martin looks like a guy who is at the counter in Mel's Diner on an episode of Alice.
There you go.
Are you talking about Earthquake in the video game? Martin would like to break it up. You'd probably talk about WrestleFest. Yeah, I remember Earthquake. Rich is keeping him snug in. Martin tried
that time to get a head scissors. When Earthquake was in the video game and he did his thing and the ring shook, right?
I think so, yeah. Sounds
about yeah.
Tento was another one that I didn't like the gimmick and I didn't get him. Because that was, again, was I tune in every now and then, and I look at this guy, and I was like, yeah, he's huge, but I know something about just the bald head and the Larry Fine hair, you know, just like, eh, he didn't look threatening to me.
No, but...
And I didn't like his finisher. I hated the finisher because I realized, I was like, well, if he did that for real, he'd kill him. So you could see him just kind of gently sitting down on guys, and I was like, yeah.
Like he did kill Damien, if you remember.
Right.
Deshaun Mooney.
Oh! And then they made burgers out of him.
Speaking of killing him, modern wrestling, the new stuff, why is everybody bringing weapons to the ring?
Like who?
Why are people bringing like swords and shields and shields?
Oh, yeah. What's his face has a sword?
Oh, well, yeah, some of the guys have their gimmicks. You see, Drew McIntyre has his sword. That's his big gimmick. And trust me, the kids love it.
I can't imagine.
He was way over.
My nephew and his buddies, they love McIntyre. On the sword. Just based on the guy that he's got a big fucking sword. And the Vikings have shields.
Yeah, the Vikings have shields.
And here's the thing. Let's get Stan Hansen standing next to Polish Power here.
Yeah. Even a great Popeye gimmick, hey? Putski.
I wonder what, you know, it makes me wonder because, so basically you have Backlund and Putski there from WWF, right? Mm-hmm. Was Mr. Saito in WWF at the time?
No, I think he had finished his run. Because,
you know, someone is sent there to, like,
be the police.
Be an enforcer for the champion.
I don't think Putski was a tough guy. He was an asshole. I know that. Bully.
Call it, Travis. Call the number.
All right.
Well, you got to. Well, or serve some reason for Bob, because Bob doesn't need someone to look out for him. He can handle.
Backlund was his own policeman.
Backlund. It wasn't like Harley Race going with Thayer to Japan. You know, Bob Backlund take care of himself. So
we can get there for three in obstructed view and one single seat. Like way in the nosebleeds.
I'll take the single seat as long as it's not obstructed.
Yeah. No, it's also obstructed.
I only go for totally obstructed.
I like to picture it in my mind.
I don't like to watch violence.
Okay, imagine being down in Georgia and you're a magazine geek. You'd be all over this fucking card, right?
Yeah, that's who this card is for, yeah.
Magazine geek, as in someone who...
For the geeks.
Yes.
Do you subscribe to Time?
Harper's Weekly.
Good
Housekeeping.
Ladies Home Journal fans are in the front row cheering on
Swank.
I need to see this Texas Death match with Big John Studd and Leroy Brown. That's got to be one of the worst matches of all time.
What happened with Saito and Sullivan, Kelly, in that match? Did you see?
Sullivan beat Saito. I guess Sullivan was still a babyface at this time.
Yes, was Sullivan the devil yet?
Not yet. No. Yeah, when he went to Florida.
Dungeon Master.
No, he was kind of he's an okay babyface.
Even before this time, he was a heel in Memphis, so maybe he could have been a heel.
Maybe. I just know I've seen him as a baby face in Georgia.
But it would, I guess Mr. Saito, he would have been a baby.
Yeah. Exactly.
He looks like day three of a Chia Pet.
I was going to say, it's like his hair has muscles. Somehow his hair is flexing. Yeah. How does he flex his hair?
I loathe the man.
He's got hair. He's got hair like the G.I. Joes from the 70s. That hair.
Yeah.
Yes. Totally.
like Moss Man from me.
Totally.
Moss.
Oh, we're getting to see Pritchard.
There was that one He-Man Pritchard? Who had like slime.
Is it though? There's a T in that.
There was a Pritchard. He-Man character That's who had Pritchard. Like slime, or one of the villains.
Oh,
is it Dr. Get that slime on Moss.
Oh, it's Ralph Emery. I know this one.
Hey, Ralph.
All my life. Hi, Ralph. I love Ralph Emery. My God, I've seen this ad so many times.
Answer the telephone.
Hello.
Oh, I get this.
Pretty original.
Wow.
Is it?
Tanya
Tucker. Right, Freddie Fender.
Way into, yeah. Never heard
Billy Crash Craddock is also a wrestler.
Yeah, these guys I'm not too familiar with.
There's a lot of here I'm not familiar with. Barbara Mandrell.
Died in a horrible car.
This is like late 70s.
There's C.W. McCall, Crystal Gale, Hank Jr., Merle Haggard. Oh, come on, we're getting some names.
Merle Haggard.
Well, now the names are getting into
Mel Tillis.
The Statesiders.
I just said, Buck Owens.
And all these people are
Tom T. Hall. He's awesome.
Soul.
The Statlers. I just got it's just gonna show country music has Dottie West. It has a.
Oh my God! There's
as many one-hit wonders that you forget about. As a
brother just
music.
Logged on to say there's a lot of DUIs for Billy Crash.
Dude, they said operators are on call 24 hours. They just said because you know what?
Wank it on the ground.
These commercials run at 3 in the morning. These guys, they're depending on shit-faced people going,
ladies
I'm going to get
gas protection. Are you kidding me? I'm Bobby Bear, baby.
I think I'd go with the
songs to listen to while driving.
Oh, don't go. Sweetheart, are you going to go home with Bobby Bear? Mm-mm. I don't think that's a good idea, honey. Tell you about something about Bobby Bear. Sometimes when you hang out with him, he hangs around a little longer, if you know what I'm saying, even if he ain't in the house.
Oh my God, this is
all your cereal.
Tom Pritchard and some dude versus it's Tom Pritchard.
Wow.
Versus all okay. This is like your okay.
This is Tom.
Tom Pritchard was like the bottom of the pecking order of baby faces in Georgia. You saw him, he was on the card, you know, did double duty, teaming with a jobber. Yeah, so that's so that's your like, hey, this could be a good match, main event of television.
This is he's a Dominic DiNucci in this tag team where he won't be taking
exactly.
The fall.
Exactly.
Man, it's just so believable. Stan Hansen's one of the most believable wrestlers I've ever seen. Maybe the most believable.
Well, he's just hurting people.
Yes.
So that's what makes it so believable.
Yeah. And he did pop Vader's eye out.
I always heard that in general he, I mean, it's all rough, but he wasn't super stiff unless it was clotheslines and shit like that.
Oh, he was
like,
just a big man. He was just a big man.
Like those are those.
And when he was doing like the King's Road stuff, like that's just par for the course. Everybody had that.
And he's over there in America. I mean, he knows how to drop those knees and not hurt anyone. He's awesome.
Yeah. Jesus, just a nightmare. He is a nightmare.
Think about it. He doesn't even have to. He doesn't even have to really slam the guys. He just lifts them up and just drops them,
yeah,
so they can just take a flat back bump because he's so tall.
Easy top 10 all time for me for sure. Nice. Oh, no, come on.
Not even a one.
Let's fuck this motherfucker up.
They're loving it. Let's go.
I'd probably put Hansen in my top 20.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm a big fan, for sure. Referee Scrappy McGowan calling
for him to break back into the center of the ring. He's no boogie woogie man Jimmy Valiant, but he's all right.
What are everyone's thoughts on Ole Anderson? The guy you don't talk too much about anymore.
I'll tell you what, when I was 15 and I first and I discovered Crockett and immediately it became my favorite wrestling, Ole Anderson was my least favorite wrestler because I thought he was fucking boring. And I thought the Andersons were fucking boring. I hated all the arm work. I was like, ugh. But then Arn was in all these like cool TV title defenses after that. And then I really was just like, fuck it, Ole. He just looked old. And
yeah.
I didn't. But he was fucking awesome. I look back now and I'm like, God. Yeah. Shit, I was in the third row. Me and Joe were for Rock and Rolls, Andersons at Starcade in the cage. Okay, that's fucking magic.
It's an awesome match.
Yeah, it's amazing.
Awesome. He was a great, great promo.
Oh, he was a great promo.
I just know him from other wrestlers' biographies. And I mean, this show.
Oh, he was a fucking asshole.
Yeah.
But I love the fact that he was an asshole to everybody. Like, he worked at
Crockett. Yeah, he was an equal opportunity asshole. For sure.
Yeah, like, he worked at Turner. And he treated people who worked at Turner like pieces of shit.
He's on fire right now.
Yeah.
Who is this?
That's Pritchard. That's Pritchard. And then he said he met his girlfriend there, and everyone just says like that she was this young hot thing who worked in the office, and no one could figure out why she was with Ole. Love them bad boys.
Oh, Johnny, I listened to the very first, my first Briscoe and
Bradshaw,
because it was just a short watch along of the Hanson Andre match.
Oh, okay.
Like 20 minutes or whatever, yeah. Right? It's awesome. I mean, that's great. Like, that's the kind of stuff I love. I love there, that match. That's an all-time favorite match.
Ooh, there it is. There it is.
James,
it's not Dr. Johnson.
Terrifying. Terrifying. Yeah.
It's gaining more and more popularity because despite some of the audio glitches of them just being like, we're not invested in any kind of fancy fucking mics for this show. And sometimes the YouTube, they're talking to old wrestlers who are sometimes in their car or can't figure out fucking Zoom.
Who but is it?
It's the Briscoe and Bradshaw. It's mainly on YouTube, but they've got a podcast of it too. And it's the best one because it's just guys fucking telling stories and Bradshaw and Briscoe just bullshitting, and it's like always super fun and funny. Some guests are better than others, definitely, but no question about that. The national heavyweight champion here he is with me right now,
and here's a man that I think
he wasn't wonderful yet.
Humble baby.
He was always wonderful. There's been a lot of
people who put their names on some contracts. I'm going to be defending this belt all over the country. There's people like Don Morocco, Jimmy Snuka. They're coming from out of the woodworks everywhere. Everybody wants a title.
The woodworks.
The national champion. The woodworks downtown.
Here comes someone to challenge him.
Here we go. Oh, God, I want to see this match.
And you better shine it up. And you better put it around your waist and take some pictures
with it on. Because it's not going to be with you long, brother. I'm going to promise see you that. Mad Dog Buzz Sawyer is wearing what would eventually be called the Hedgepeth look. almost every dead show I was ever at. No, the fucking do-rag, bandana do-rag on the head. Be it with long hair flowing out because I was balding up top. But even before I was balding, I always wore a do-rag.
Why did you retire the do-rag, Johnny?
I still wear it every now and then.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I'll put it on. I'll bring it back. Well deserved the title. I'm always bringing sexy back. I just don't. I'm not going to put it on for the fucking podcast. Tell you what, I'll bring it to Vancouver. Leave me in my fucking.
You give me a red one. Bring me a red one because I'm starting to have second thoughts about putting on a turban. You know what I mean? In 2022,
yeah.
When I'm going to be.
I've been looking at a lot of thrift stores. It's going to be difficult to. Duplicate that.
The canary.
I wouldn't. Dude, it's but if you do the suit with it and everything, it's clearly fucking over the top. It's not something you have to fucking worry about.
I just love to have the canary yellow blazer.
I know.
How are we cursed with Chick Donovan? Is this fucking Chick Donovan?
I believe it is, yeah.
I've seen more fucking Chick Donovan on this fucking show.
Yeah.
Bad Penny.
Be the mascot of Mystery Titans here. Chick Donovan.
And the difference that that can make in the ring. Chick Donovan.
Stretch Armstrong.
Really? What's funny is if I want to be accurate for the manager's ceremony thing, yeah. I got to find some just old fat man polyester outfit like my grandfather would have worn, because Albano wasn't in the Hawaiian shirt.
Not yet.
Or anything.
No, but yours should be easy to put together. He just was wearing a white button-up short sleeve shirt.
Shirt and
like
and
fat black slacks, I think.
I gotta go to the thrift store and get the accurate.
James is talking about he might be able to make the trip.
Well, I was gonna ask if I'm coming. Who? Who am I?
We need a Scullin, man. We need an Arnold.
Yeah, well, Arnold Scullin.
What am I gonna do about the hair?
Get a wig. I'm getting a fake beard. I'm getting a fake beard. I can't grow my beard for this.
Yeah, you got it.
Kids from Stranger
and
Things.
And I gotta get it.
And I gotta wear a wig too. Dude, I gotta go. So a good
counter by wrestling. Oh, I suppose. Yeah. Those, yeah.
What the heck?
Hello.
All right, I'll come.
What the fuck was that?
That's what convinced you. That guy's beautiful.
That was the sign. If there was ever a sign.
Yeah, that face just appeared and said, "You gotta fucking wear the wig, motherfucker."
You're gonna go.
Get a leg or an arm outside. Being a fucking prima donna, wear the fucking wig.
Now we go right, to the NASCAR race. That
was insane.
Forget about Chick Donovan.
Yeah, no, he's the best. Do we release a still for this? Because that should be the still.
Yeah.
I gotta find it.
You gotta isolate that and just put it in every fucking show.
Oh, God.
Chick Donovan looks like Tara Rising.
Yeah,
I can see
totally
it.
Does. Yeah.
Dude, I love that this whole Vince thing is just feels like something out of Dallas or Succession.
Totally. Succession, totally. Because
I'm like, all right, I'm going to fantasy book this shit, like I said. Stephanie and Triple H were the ones who fucking leaked the information to the Wall Street Journal.
Do you think?
No, but I want to.
Yeah,
exactly.
I really want to.
Makes her a great story.
Oh, it's wonderful. I never thought
think
it
about
would
that.
Happen in my
think
lifetime.
About that. You gave my husband a fucking heart attack and tore everything down.
Yeah.
I know she. We know where all the bodies are buried. Yeah. And suddenly this happens. That's what I think.
When she gets. Don't
I also think that's why she went out when she went out on SmackDown or whatever and was like, thank you, Vince. Thank you, Smix. And I love you, Dad. He knew back home watching that she didn't mean a fucking word of it. I'm going to totally fit. This is fucking Dallas for real.
Meanwhile, Shane is just trying to avoid all the drug charges. Or whatever. Like, there's something wrong with Shane.
I remember 2022 started with the Shane McMahon.
Oh, I know what's wrong with Shane.
The Shane McMahon Royal Rumble fiasco. It's been such a weird...
That's a weird one. I know what's wrong with Shane is his dad never really fucking liked him.
Oh, wow.
He went from being someone that everyone backstage always had great things to say about, though. Like, yeah, we all fucking love him, the crazy motherfucker.
Yeah.
But then he turns into fucking...
What the fuck is Shane doing here?
Yeah, well, no, he also turns into dad, like, fucking, like, in his, you know, in his 40s, he's suddenly jacked and wearing, he's like one of those dads, and you can tell he's like that in real life, and, leading to the Royal Rumble stuff and everything, all just because his fucking crazy father always told him he was disappointed in him. He's got to be on a lot of blow. He seems like he's on a lot of blow.
Oh, constant.
I started reading the newsletter, Kelly. I got about 15 minutes in.
It's epic. It took me over an hour, I think, to read the whole thing.
That's the craziest thing when you're reading
what newsletter
a
Meltzer, is that?
The Wrestling Observer newsletter.
Oh,
Meltzer thing, and you start to scroll. You start to scroll and you see, like, you've been reading for a while and you see that you're barely on the side about how far you're going down.
Yeah.
It, It's one of the longest pieces he's ever done. Yeah. Obviously, I mean,
is it on the McMahon
thing?
Biggest
stories ever.
Yeah,
yeah, because it comes out Friday, so this is the first time he wrote about it.
You know what's
Vince
interesting?
Announced his retirement last Friday.
You know what gets me is Freddie Prinze Jr. is coming out with all this shit now about how the writer's room worked during his time. He was there for like
a
two and a half
years.
Dude,
he's the best. He was on Briscoe and Bradshaw. Dude, that motherfucker is crazy, don't give a fuck, and is the best.
Yeah.
I've heard.
Like the NDA must have run out or something. Like,
yeah,
right.
Dude, he was raised by all of Hollywood's
what's
like,
the timer?
Tough guys.
Yeah.
And trained by all them and everything. Yeah,
10 minutes time.
I
guess.
Yeah, Chick Donovan. Oh no.
Why is there a timer? Why is there a countout?
Nice.
So Mr. Wrestling 2 can win with just 1 second left.
Oh yeah.
I think
his gimmick at the time was you had to beat him in 10 minutes or
you
something
beat
like that.
Mr. Wrestling too,
and you'd
yeah.
maybe get like $5,000, $10,000. I'm not 100% sure.
Just admit. That pose from Hulk.
Oh, everyone, even them, because Rocky 3 was out by this time, right?
Mm-hmm.
Everyone put, if Hogan had ever been in your fucking promotion, and this is before Hulkamania, WWF.
This was like a good 3 years after he was there. Coming up next,
enjoy another tons. Hour of
championship oh, wrestling. What's it going to be?
That's followed by the roar of the engines on Motor Week Illustrated. Then take a look at this weekend
baseball. Webs, baby. Oh, man.
This
I
era.
Love, this weekend.
This era of TBS just fills me with so many good memories of the summers. No, the summers I got to spend for like a week or two at my aunt's in Kentucky, and my cousins who had more money than we did, Central Air and cable TV and a nice house, and it was great. And I got to watch a lot of TV, and I just all this just. I wasn't watching this wrestling at the time though, but like every fucking commercial here. I'm like, also, the magnificent
I'll
the
be
old
back
home week.
During this next hour, we'll be talking to the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes. We'll see the Samoans, and we'll be seeing Brad Armstrong. The young man has been nominated.
Hey, Brad Armstrong.
Nope, look who's back. Like I've changed my shirt 7 times. All of a sudden, the fishermen come in and say, there's one 12 plus. It's a big one. He's awesome at this time. He is coked to the gills. You're
and
right.
Then you load the spear gun, you go
Donnie,
deep
we love you,
for
man.
Him.
And just answer my emails. I can't call
evilly,
him
evilly,
that ship has sailed.
Dusty Rhodes, and you have him in your sights.
Evilly?
At those eyes bulging out of the side of his head.
Crazy.
Bulging.
He doesn't have this.
And then you wonder.
This voice. Then you wonder. This accent's a little different.
Are you looking for the shock, or is the shock looking for you? Dusty Rhodes got his.
Like he's sounding like Dusty Rhodes. I guess it's because he's in the South. Everybody has to put on a...
Yeah.
I don't know.
Oh, no. He's just what Morocco talked like.
Kind of different style, slightly. That's why he won't come on this year.
He played tomorrow, see. It's pretty good, though. What's the shirt say? He's going to have to come. Water safety.
Harper Valley officer. Something officer.
Safety officer.
Health safety.
It's
water safety officer. He's a lifeguard.
Yeah.
He's a fucking lifeguard. Beach bum my ass.
Yeah.
He's out there saving lives.
Certified. I took the life saving lesson.
He's swimming you in. He's swimming you in and telling you off in that voice.
Hit the free second time we heard Freebird.
Here we go.
Play it the whole fucking
I am unashamedly a huge Skinner fan of, you know, the original.
Skinner?
Not the current incarnation.
I didn't know there was a current
incarnation. Yeah,
oh, there has
new
been.
One?
There has been
there's
since
a new
89.
Skinner?
There has been since 89. I don't even know how many original members are left in it, but.
It's like how Chicago keeps changing members.
Yeah. And it went from being like, yeah, they're Southern rock, but, you know, yeah, okay, they used the Stars and Bars, and a lot of people did back then, but, you know, you never really heard, like, Leonard Skinner were notorious racists. I don't think they were. everything, but, and now, you know, like, their fan base is for these shows, they may as well be opening for Trump. I mean, it's...
Oh, no.
It ain't good.
They're still touring? That's crazy. I couldn't name you. I can name two Skinners.
Really? Really?
Sweet Home Alabama.
And they're both 17 minutes long. So
yeah,
that's plenty.
Well, Freebird's really long, and everything else is relatively short.
Yeah, that's
one long song.
I like Shambhala. Is that a...
That's Three Dog Night. But listen, I could sit here and rattle
Simple
off
Man
Skinner.
Really
so far, I could rattle. Give me back my bullets. That was the Briscoes theme song.
In ROH. Yeah.
Oh yeah,
it was awesome. I literally could just list them all because in high school, there were certain tapes that everybody had in the car for driving around, and the two tape Lynyrd Skynyrd's greatest hits was constantly played.
Look at that all blue, ref. As popular as they we're gonna add be, it. We're gonna add something afterwards. It's like blue screen.
He's one of those. He's one of those jumpsuit refs that they used to have down in the South, right?
Numbers today. Everybody's doing well out there. Gordy watching. Moves in. Gordy
punishing the back of Dale Vesey. Vince Senior nor Vince Junior ever had any tolerance for the referees in the onesies. No fucking way.
Right. Is that to walk in on that? If you walk in on them using the bathroom, they're completely naked.
Yeah, exactly.
Their pants are pulled down to their ankles. Just
occupied. Occupied. Oh man, we watched two kids in the hall though. And they're both. They're so. We always like. Well, man, maybe Nora shouldn't have watched that. It's pretty raunchy. She loves Kids in the Hall.
What, the new ones or the old ones?
Yeah.
They're great. They're fucking great.
They're good. But watch both episodes of The Rehearsal so far. James, have you been watching that with Nathan Fielder?
Oh my god. Yes.
He's
crazy.
He's the man. That's such a wild.
And the guy with the trivia, he was like, "Oh, I won. We finally won."
So fucked.
And then him telling him, "Oh no, I mind fucked you." And
yeah,
knowing the trivia answer
to the fake version, but not to the real.
The fake, but I didn't know. You don't know for sure whether he did tell.
So that shows like he's got a bit of like self-examination kind of happening with this too. Like, am I kind of? Is this unethical?
The whole scene with him in the swimming pool. Well, I was married for 3 years. He's treading water.
Yeah, it's awesome.
I was married
Matt.
For 3 years.
Did you watch Nathan For You at all, Johnny?
No.
Oh my God.
He's
the man.
Brilliant man. Yeah. It's so good. Yeah. It's awkward to a funny level. Barry Gordy moves in, glancing blow off the chest. Of Martin catches Martin on the top of the head, and Martin ripping across the face of Terry Gordy.
Michael Hayes has the same job.
It's the same guy. It's that guy.
Our guy.
Travis. Travis, just give me a holler when you get to the Kids in the Hall app with the greatest Zoom call bit I've ever seen.
I think that's what we saw. That was second episode.
Oh, was that second episode where they're all masturbating during the Zoom call? That's one of the funniest goddamn things I've ever seen.
Like, should we have let Nora see this?
You should have. That was one of the funniest goddamn skits.
Pretty funny, yeah. We laughed a lot.
If you're ever up to it, the documentary that's also on Prime.
I need to watch that documentary. Yeah. No, I heard the makers of it were on Dana Gould's podcast, and I was waiting for it to drop.
I know that Paul Myers wrote the biography. Mike Myers' brother wrote
That's who was on the podcast.
Oh, so is he on the documentary as well?
He's part of it. I think he's part of it.
He's an interesting guy. Follow him on Twitter.
And surprisingly enough, Bellini has a lot to say.
Really?
Yeah. Talk to him a lot.
Remember, there's so much male nudity in those first two episodes.
Mm-hmm.
And or like there's a moment where they're teasing that he's gonna take the towel off. I'm like, are we gonna see Bellini's dink? Are we gonna no, he's just wearing another towel. And
you'll never see Bellini's dink.
Great spot.
No, there's in the later episodes there's equal amounts of male nudity.
Yeah.
Yeah.
See that I'm fine. Like I think it's really healthy to have my daughter laugh at male nudity. I think that's really good.
Oh sure.
Yeah.
Just You can just point at it and laugh.
Exactly.
That's
James. Best James, thing. James, I'm not going to give it away because I don't think they've seen this yet. But just the darkest recurring bit I think I've ever seen on a sketch show is a post-apocalyptic DJ.
Oh my God. That was brilliant. Yes. So yes, it's so right. Good. The way he just looks off into nothing.
Who is it? McCullough?
No, it's
what's his face from News Radio?
It's Foley.
Foley.
Yeah, Dave Foley.
It's so dark and so funny.
It's really good.
And just, it's amazing. Here we go.
This is gonna, holy shit.
Uh-oh, you dead, buddy.
Oh. Styles Cloud.
Oh!
Wow. Wow.
Nuts and a couple Gordies in
you
your
didn't
mouth.
You do that in road class.
You think the Von Erichs were gonna take that shit?
No.
Get him strutting.
Or even the jobbers. The jobbers down there. No, what jobbers? They only did main event guys.
They didn't really have too many jobbers.
Iceman on the same time.
You haven't even touched that sucker. I'm beginning to think that's just a prop.
And he's like, Gordon, I'm doing this to quit smoking cigarettes. I'm a three packs of lollipop a day.
I have type one
in an hour.
Hard cam, Gordon. Hard cam.
Sonny King is a giant man. Look at the size. That's one of those weird things. I'm gonna be a manager and I'm fucking huge. It's always weird. Oh, what are they gonna say to Sonny King? Hold on. I'm waiting for him to say something racist to Sonny King.
It is Michael Hayes.
Careful, Mike. If you want it, you gotta take
it. Let's get before the, you know, we don't want anyone to get canceled here. Seriously.
I love that guitar.
The bouncing exclamation point.
Yeah.
Good.
Thor
and Giffenakara.
The mascot, a short-lived mascot.
The name of a future
old exclaimy.
Exclaimy. What's this chick got going on? Ooh, that's so hot.
Do you want to eat ice cream?
Ice creamery. Oh, I remember this. Shit.
And you can clean your floors with it.
Yeah. I was gonna say, why'd you put it on the tile? Why is it your compost? Ingredients. Mix with a wooden spoon, then turn on the automatic ice creamery. Smell it.
Silently.
Smell the.
How to make your own liverwurst. Mix and chill, and look at the result.
Yeah. Smooth, cold, creamy. You can make cat food.
That's good salmon.
Fresh fruit strawberry, zesty mocha. All so incredibly easy. You just pour, dip, and chill. Watch. On the left is expensive grocery store vanilla.
Let's compare the ingredients.
Watch. Look at that cardboard box.
No wonder all the. Let's look.
Where can we find now that? Ice creamery.
Non-fat sugar.
Disgusting. No wonder ice cream machines. Should be
oh, no, it had non-fat milk in it.
It's not bad, actually. Hey, check out this.
I'm taking a small
$350 for a
I'm taking a small bite because we're going to have to do 120 takes.
Yeah.
Why is this lady
do not
eating
eat the cones?
The Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints.
Cones not included. The book of low-calorie ice cream. Yours free with the fabulous automatic ice creamery. Oh, do you get the popping tray?
I think it'd be a really good thing. For rush delivery,
use your charge and call. How much is it? That's very reasonable.
Hi, I'm Mr. Creamery, Ice Creamery.
To Ice Creamery, Box 7500, Atlanta, Georgia,
30. Ice Cream.
Faster service. The ladies now toll free 1-800-257-1234.
Uh-oh.
Harold, it almost looks like it's like Tony Gurria's refereeing.
Doing a bit of moonlighting. Down in Georgia.
The Samoans are making quick work of this situation.
I want everybody take a good look at the Samoans.
So was this like, are they working again too, or is this two shows? Like this has been a 2 hour.
That's what I was just wondering. Are they
2 hours? But they treated
it's a 2 hour show, but they're having guys work twice in the 2 hours.
Yeah.
Uh huh. Okay.
Well, yeah. that would be dull. That would be dull for a Saturday. We're doing it right now.
At this point.
Well, that's exactly what we're doing.
It's better for a Friday night. Forget about a Saturday afternoon.
Hey, kayfabe, brother. Yeah. Brother the YouTubers.
That's right. That's
all right.
Gene Caro and Rick Thor have not had an
opportunity. I would imagine it also has a lot to do with, oh, we're on for 2 fucking hours. Some people might be watching something else for that first hour. Tune in here and want to see the stars.
Viewers until later on today.
In between, the wrestlers just like go back and have some, I don't know.
Play some pinochle.
They play some pinochle. What does Samoans eat?
McDonald's, just like the rest of them.
What the hell's that?
You're a racist motherfucker,
James.
Aren't you?
Yes. No, that's not what I meant.
Fish. First thing, fish.
Well, on
yes,
TNT,
we're all fish.
Yeah, that's what I was referring to, the TNT segment where they ate raw fish and raw
I know. Didn't they make it like a raw fish smoothie?
Yeah, I think so, in the blender. Yeah. And Vince was like, oh, I want to get in the blender.
I know. Yes, you'd always have to sell it.
Made Lord Al drink some of it first.
Remember how mad that's he right. got when who fired the gun off? Was it Schultz? No, somebody fired a gun off.
I don't think that's
Dr. D.
Was it?
During when it
fuck
it
all, like
he went to his house to visit his family.
No, he didn't know.
It was on the set. It was on set.
An interview.
Schultz, he fired off.
Okay.
And he fired off when they went to interview his family, and he was talking about, and he was like, "I'm gonna smack you."
Like that's my favorite wrestling vignette of all time.
Did he not shoot a gun?
No, he doesn't shoot a gun. He doesn't shoot a gun. He threatens to beat his children and yells at his wife, and he's wearing a rope belt.
Yes, of course.
It's the funniest. It's the best. Right before he's like, I'm in line to go in the space shuttle, Gene. I built this cabin with my bare hands. Because I'm a real man, Gene. What's this, woman? There's all the dishes in the sink.
Yes.
He walks in, he's like, what's this, city dump?
What are you smiling at? Who are you smiling
at? Eat your bread. Eat that bread. Eat it. What's this? I told you we had the TV people coming over, woman.
At this point, if we're able to reunite another October, we're going to have to reenact that Tuesday Night Titans.
Oh, dude, if we reenact that, I'll
be a new tradition.
Dibs on the wife.
I'm Dr. D, obviously. Of course. Dibs on the wife. We got two kids, the wife, and you don't even see the interviewer, actually.
No.
I could throw bread at one of you while you try not to break character and laugh.
I'm going to like cry for what's her name from The Shining.
And she did have a bit of a Shelley Duvall thing going.
Yeah, Shelley Duvall. Yeah.
And young Shelley Duvall, and is the hottest thing ever. I'm just seeing like pictures of like her from back then.
No, I'm all about the Popeye Shelley Duvall.
Yeah.
That's a thing. That's a.
Very
I'm all about
fetish.
The post Stanley Kubrick turning her into a psychotic Shelley Duvall.
Yeah, there's a recent story.
Is she better? I haven't heard since she was on Dr. Phil.
Yeah, it sounds like she's.
She's better?
Yeah.
I hope so.
Kind of more at peace.
Which one was
Dr.
Thor?
Dr. Phil's a fucking monster. But yeah, which one's sucks. Thor? You're Thor.
Outside the ring.
The guy laying in the ring looks pretty Thor.
You're Thor. I'm so Thor I can hardly piss.
That joke was probably huge in July of 1982, James. Whatever that punchline.
Yeah,
this was probably the heyday of whatever that
Morocco.
Joke was.
Morocco. Third promo.
Monday in Gainesville, Florida, the Stephen O'Connell Center. Want him to have a new shirt. Tickets are available. Like something that says, like, I'm a pepper. On Thursday night,
he's proud. He's proud to be a lifeguard. They call him a beach bum. He's there for a reason.
I got a shift coming up. I'm really excited.
I'm saving lives, Gordy.
Mike gets to do some mouth-to-mouth, Gordy.
The sad thing is he actually worked at a pool, and not at a beach.
Yeah,
it's a kid's pool.
Indoor. It's 8 feet deep.
At the local rec center.
Yep. Waiting for, they actually don't. They're not required.
He's yelling at the old ladies doing water aerobics.
He has to put down a deposit for the orange thing.
Even here, man, they were touring all the way up.
This is when they
use it at all.
Started doing shows in Michigan and Ohio. Or in
West Virginia. They're already touring up to Michigan.
There was the old, the old Detroit territory, the Sheik's territory, because it had gone on belly up.
This is crazy dog paddle behind it. He doesn't know how to swim.
He can't swim at all.
Not a lick.
He's actually afraid of the water. And tomorrow night, of course,
the American Dream Dusty. They keep putting up a poster about trying to find out who's pissing on the sauna rocks.
It's clearly Don.
It's always been Don.
They just have to find a way to do it nicely.
Please stop pissing on the sauna rocks. We have no idea who you are. Stop it.
It lasts for days. Putrid. Two good Dusty promos on this. There you go. Now he's finally got a.
There we go. That
there he is. Jeez. Hulk Hogan, eat your heart out.
Yeah.
Unfortunately, that's his only shirt.
I'm loving Dusty's bling here. Looking good.
They had to cut away from the nudity.
They were like, are those tits?
Oh my god. We can see the birthmark. Cut away. The birthmark, visible birthmark.
Give it up.
Like, remember when we were listening to the guys in the truck for that? What was that show? That was a Memphis show, right, Kelly? That
you
got to hear the whole.
Remember, we could hear the.
This
is so sexy.
That was ICW.
Yeah, you're right. Yeah.
It was a very Von Erich heavy show. I remember.
Holy shit. Dude, how? I don't know about up there. Up there. I cannot tell you. I cannot tell you.
Time Life book.
How many homes had these fix-it books?
Really?
Holy shit. Yeah.
My Uncle Harvey had them, for sure.
We never had them. My dad did.
There must be PDFs of them out on the internet. Oh,
we had the ones.
There's PDFs about, of all the, like, those weird, Time Life books about paranormal and unexplained.
Are the ones we had. Those. We actually had them in the mail as a kid. Yeah.
We all wanted totally those, man. When you were a kid, you loved that shit.
The covers had, like, fur on them. The covers were, like, crazy. Like weirdly embossed and
not just the Bigfoot one.
We had them all.
I had lots of like individual volumes and stuff because my dad was an auctioneer
and a big magazine geek.
No, yeah.
Just bring it back.
But no, there was a lot of like, you know, here's a pile of shit that we're fucking of books and stuff that nobody wanted, and I'd always like get them.
Read them quick, or I'm gonna sell them.
Yeah, you know, it was like there's a bunch of books. I just remembered constantly having like. To order your first book for a 15-day exam. I had one of the paranormals. I had that's 1-800-257. One Civil War one, like two Wild West. You know,
right. I remember a lot of those.
We had a Wild West one.
Yeah, I think my grandpa did too.
Yeah. The supernatural ones that had one on like dragons. Okay, there was one on ghosts.
Hilarious.
There was one on.
Yeah, there's got to be PDFs.
Vampires, I think. Yeah. Who's that guy? Oh no. That's my dream haircut, right?
Yeah, he doesn't tear. See, he doesn't tear that shirt off because he knows that he knows what that shirt represents.
Loses deposit.
It's his only shirt, and he can't get back to the rec center.
Yeah.
The only way
can't
in.
Get back in.
Again, it's again the nudity laws in Georgia. Really weird at this time.
I male do nipples. Like
male
I
nipples.
Do,
it was like, the summer of 1982. There's a weird thing about male nipples in Georgia.
We just there was one weird like preacher who was like.
The devil.
Ooh, nice.
Is Kelly adjusting his screen with his toe? Because that's disgusting. Is that your
box eye
view?
Oh, that's my hand. Sorry.
Oh, okay.
I can't even see on the tablet.
Can't move. It's like Misery. Someone's gonna come in and hobble him and like.
That's like
what
he's saying.
I can't
see myself.
Doctor now.
R.I.P. James.
Who's that? Oh, James Bond. Dangerous adversary.
Sternum first. That's where Brett got it. I don't think that guy had a choice. He's really getting thrown.
Yeah, I don't think so.
The
this looks like this guy's got a mustache, right? Okay, I'm trying to do some facial recognition on which. Okay, this is the guy who played Maud's husband, right? No.
He's the guy in The Jerk with the thing on his glasses.
I know who you're talking about, but I, you know who he is? He's the guy who always goes to the restaurant that Grover works at.
I gotta tell you, Charlie.
I love it. Dude, the little throwaways from Grover when he walks to the back room there are fucking hilarious. Frank Oz, killing it.
Keep it up, Frank.
Oh, I don't even know what I'm doing. Somebody that. Oh my gosh.
I thought this was a pool.
It's almost like a. What do you call that? A gotch pile driver?
Spike? I think it's Spike.
Didn't he call, isn't there, it was the Spike pile driver.
But what's the. Like similar to what Claudio finishes with. What do you call that?
Yeah,
like neutralizer.
The over.
Yeah.
The neutralizer. The over, oh, he
comes
the,
from. It comes from an old name. Like, I think it is something like that.
That he won. Oh, well, that's the. Yeah, gotch catcher or something like that. But. Yeah. But that's a face first. But he won the ROH belt with
Haven't I talked enough, Gord?
I've been here 7 hours.
Seriously,
Gord.
Carry it. Carry this show for a minute and a half. Can you do that?
Hey, hold on. Since this Paul Orndorff promo is going to stink.
He has changed shirt.
I'd like the shirt. It looks good.
Looks like a Duke boy.
He does look like a Duke. If he had replaced John Schneider, I would have really watched that show. But have you guys heard about old Jonathan Gresham blowing up with Tony Khan?
Right, whatever that was, yeah.
Well, because he was losing the belt to Claudio. And he, fuck you, I quit. Whatever, and all this shit. There's a rumor, and God, I want it to be true, that was out on Twitter, that when someone overheard him yelling, he quoted, he's like, his number in the PWI 500.
I know, I've seen that.
That's how important he is. And holy shit, I want that to be true.
Yeah.
That's fucking awesome. I'd fucking love that.
Yeah, Gresham. I used to really like Jordan Grace, and I hear the Impact women's division is really good. I hear it's like one of the good things about Impact. But both of them, like, she had that fiasco with Benoit's son recently.
Yeah. I don't know quite the details,
they just seem they're so public and so just like out there, but like don't have the savvy to be. As outspoken as they are, and then to hear that kind of thing, like that kind of marks for themselves a bit. I think that's the impression I get from both of them.
And he's, because I'm a great technical wrestler too, and he is, and here's the thing. Oh, during these lean years, has he held it together there? Sure, but this relaunch, I watched that pay-per-view. It's a fucking relaunch of the Ring of Honor that I used to watch. It brought back the Embassy.
Right.
Nana and the Embassy, and it's the best Embassy yet. It was amazing. Claudio is going to finally win the fucking belt. We're going to roll the clock back. The Briscoes are there. Dalton Castle. They're bringing back the hits of the mid-2000s. Samoa Joe. I mean, that's what they're doing. So, thanks, but you know, for him to be pissy about, like, you have to lose to Claudio.
Yeah.
You know, who's like...
You have a job.
He's like 4 feet taller than you.
Yeah.
Friday Night Forever. You didn't have this one.
What he did.
We had a four
side one.
We had a four album like 50s rock and roll collection.
Oh, we got so many of those from the Petrocan. We had so many of those like all.
Yeah, I had a few of the tapes.
I would have loved to have. I wish we had this one. I love literally every song on this.
Yeah,
that's good stuff. It's like that movie. What's that movie? The Wanderers.
Yeah.
Have you seen the Wanderers?
Yes. We've
this is the soundtrack to The Wanderers.
We used to love it. Like that fight scene where they start swinging that dude
best.
Around. So
Stucky funny. Boys. Stucky Boys.
Used to be A&E every couple
Okay, Travis, what's that term you use that I hate for songs? Stone Cold Classics. Every single one of these.
Oh, yeah.
Every single one of these is.
Sure. Yep.
I'm such a Motown geek.
Everybody
they're all good stuff.
Smokey Robinson was so
Motown.
Yeah, Smokey Robinson was so good and at writing songs and such a good guy. He'd write songs that he could have made number one and go, I'm gonna give it to this guy because and this gal's because they need it. Because he's fucking Smokey Robinson. He was that good.
Why can you only listen to them on
Jersey
Friday?
Guy again? Jesus Christ.
You don't want to listen to that
because it's a racist.
I'm gonna give you some fucking Bruce.
You can get the country music collection 24/7. Only Friday
night
can you get the Motown one.
Motown.
A more Chick Donovan.
Dick.
Chicken. What? That
Archie's original name. Kelly, right?
This is gonna be
Archie Andrews' original name was Chick.
Chick
real name.
Like,
that's what he wanted to be called.
One
was Chick.
Panel in the first appearance, and then they decided
it's like a double feature, and he does look like Rocky Horror.
But then it became that was the name. Of, that's
he
the
does
name
look
Betty's
like Rocky Horror
on Riverdale. Boy, I saw someone did a long thread of everything that's happened in Riverdale. Goodness gracious! Goodness
oh, it's
gracious.
Insane. I gave up on it because I didn't because I was like, I don't want to watch them as grown-ups, so I'm done. But that first four seasons, I was super into it.
Yeah. Now, Julie and I were going to the bitter end, even though Well, it's, easy, disposable TV on Netflix, whatever.
Oh, eventually I'm going to need something
it's
to...
So
gonna,
yeah.
I gave up season one.
Really
my,
but yeah,
Pat,
I did season one.
Keeps...
I did about season one. I don't think I finished season one, but I liked it. I mean, I thought it was fine.
I loved it.
I think Kat gave up at one point. But...
Yeah.
I just loved it as well. And Kelly, you know this, especially because here's another thing they ran out of. Weird, random Archie characters. References. There's only so many. There's only so many. And that was my favorite part of the first couple seasons where like Archie's fake ID is the character who they spun off has Archie. They ripped themselves off.
Oh, the Wilkin
with Wilkin.
Boy?
Yeah, the Wilkin boy.
Wilkin the Willie Wilkin or whatever.
Yeah. That's the name of his fake ID.
Remember, Fangs Fogarty?
Fangs
Fogarty, do you ever show up in Riverdale?
Yeah.
Oh, Fangs is a major character.
Yeah, Fangs.
He's a sexy bisexual biker.
Strong supporting character.
What about Ambrose?
Ambrose?
No.
Been a little Ambrose yet?
No,
from the little Archies.
Yeah. There's never been a little Ambrose in Riverdale. That's a pretty
Archie.
Good.
Never...
Oh, Ambrose was Ambrose like the Dalton
never in the
was the nerd.
Like a red
he was nervous.
Never saw his face. Little Ambrose.
Ambrose, I don't think.
Of course.
They're saving Ambrose for that last season that they cancel Legends of Tomorrow, but they're keeping this fucking show going, even though most of the cast has said they'd like to move on.
Eventually, they'll have to go back in time. So maybe they need a little Ambrose to facilitate the time travel.
They really have it, Little Jinx.
I don't think Little Jinx has entered yet. I don't know if Little Jinx was actually in the Archieverse. The
universe. I don't know if she was. Katie Keene, does she count?
Oh, shit. Yeah. Dude, there was a Katie Keene spinoff that ran for one season.
Hmm. Yeah. Yeah, no, they had most of the characters at one point.
What about Jughead's dog? What's his name?
Hot Dog? Hot Dog's in it eventually.
Jelly Bean.
Have they done Archie Zombies?
Did they do a zombie one? Yeah, they've gone weird. I don't know, but I'm sure they've gotten close to it because Sabrina has been brought into it too. So.
What? Why is he touching?
I don't know. I don't get it either.
It's literally great. They're literally probably one of the only better matches we're going to see tonight. And we're talking Archie. I love this show. Look at Brad Armstrong's hair. Look at that hair on
Willie Ames.
Hair.
That's like awesome. Willie Ames.
He's a Willie Ames.
205, 207. Charles in charge of
Willie Ames also starred as the lead in a Christian superhero TV show.
Yeah, Bible Man.
Right?
I've seen every episode.
Really? Okay.
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
It's not good.
What? No, that is shocking.
The latest episode of one of my favorite podcasts, Good Christian Fun, we're talking about an episode of Bible Man. It was great.
What's Chick Donovan's career highlight?
Standing next to Kerry Von Erich when he holds up the belt. When he wins the title. That's the most anyone has ever seen of Chick Donovan.
Amen.
He got recognized in an IHOP one time.
He was wearing the rainbow suspenders and no shirt. We know he's
working, right?
Hey,
I see a picture
of
him recently.
Oh, God. It wouldn't surprise me, but I don't know.
Okay, so who's who? Now who's Rocky Horror?
Rocky Horror. Chick Donovan working the chin lock and Brad Armstrong's in the
train.
Sword of Damocles is hanging.
He does totally look like... Touch me. He does totally look like Terror Rising era Triple H.
Yeah.
Terror Rising, I forgot about that.
We used to chant, fuck a fuck a fuck a fuck me.
Mm. It's incumbent upon
him now if he can. That was the thing when Triple H first showed up when he was terrorizing? People thought he was Rocky Horror?
No.
That would have been awesome.
There are some similarities.
Yes, the WWE audience in 1995 also huge Rocky Horror. The only people who went to Rocky Horror, the only people in that audience who went to Rocky Horror were me. And those goth kids who they'd paint up and stick up there as Undertaker fans.
Right.
But they got great seats.
Great seats. His creatures of the night.
Creatures of the night.
See? It's right there.
That's a pretty good gimmick. I wish we knew somebody in the wrestling biz that we...
I know. Uh-oh. Someone in the wrestling biz whose audience is full of ironic hipsters who love a Rocky Horror.
I wish
character.
We knew somebody.
I don't know.
Like
you talk to there's somebody who might be into it. You can talk to when you guys, if you guys come out. Everybody's more than willing to listen to your ideas. We know Johnny will be there. I was telling Kelly.
I don't have any ideas.
I was telling Kelly about an upcoming plan. You did tease that I've got a bit of a bumper in between this and the. We gotta promote the shit out of this thing.
All right. Oh yeah. I'll tell you about it when you. We'll talk about it afterwards.
It's riveting match. But seriously, was Chick Donovan
bad,
have any feuds? Yeah. But does he have any feuds?
I don't know. Not that I've ever heard of.
Kelly?
No, I don't. I don't know enough about him though.
he's just always around, man.
Primarily Southern territory guy.
He's too much of a personality. I mean, he's like, he does look like a He-Man near like or Stretch Armstrong.
Okay, Chick Donovan is when they came up. No, when they came up with the name Journeyman.
Oh, that was cool.
Two cheeks.
Journeyman is a guy like Chick Donovan. Chick Donovan. Chick Donovan, I saw a picture of him recently. He's an old jacked man.
I know, that's what we saw. Yeah, it's crazy.
That's it.
Got him.
We don't get to see that. He hadn't developed that sweet Russian leg sweep yet. There's a young Brad Armstrong.
Mm-hmm. Rookie of the year, I believe, Brad Armstrong.
I remember seeing Brad Armstrong. When Brad Armstrong was
all about that,
you know, at the middle of the card in Crockett around 86. And I got to see him live a few times and watch him on TV. I just remember being like, I'm thinking to myself, this guy's the smoothest professional wrestler I've ever seen in my life. With me right now, of course, the managing editor of Inside Wrestling, Wrestler Magazine. Bob Armstrong is the managing editor.
I want to say I had John Grisham at 22. And Claudio Castellano at 33. So
I'm Bill Apter.
I don't know what the hell.
I'm Bill Apter, and nothing gets between me and my Jordashes. What the fuck is Bill Apter wearing?
Packing an iguana and
giant belt buckle.
Why is he wearing a long skirt? It's just a long pencil skirt.
Not only does he have the belt buckle, why is he wearing denim a money belt? Skirt. He's got some kind of European money belt on.
Designer Jean Cowboy Bill Apter goes into the pantheon of the greatest things ever on this show.
Why does he have a diaper on?
By the Skywalker.
When I brought home the Rookie of the Year award and Brad looked at that thing and he said, Dad, congratulations. And never did I think that Brad would be wrestling and he too would win the Rookie of the Year award. We are the only father and son team. I've looked back in the archives so far. We're the only father. Both Rookie of the Year. Okay, I didn't know Pro Wrestling Illustrated was handing out the Rookie of the Year award in 1962.
Yeah, no, I don't know, and it wasn't. No,
that's great.
I mean, yeah,
I love that magazine. That magazine was awesome.
I think. Like 72 is the first award, if I'm not mistaken. Let's take a look.
I'm sure he was given some Rookie of the Year award, or he's like, fuck it, let's make it up.
Is he like a late bloomer?
I don't think so. The late bloomer.
Like, I mean, he didn't get into wrestling until he was a little older.
I got back from Vietnam because I served in Vietnam in 1972. Immediately got into pro wrestling and Rookie of the Year.
Rookie of the Year.
Herbs were fucking huge.
He's so fucking good.
Georgia in 82. Everybody had a perm.
It cannot be overstated how fucking popular Bob Armstrong was in the South.
It was a really nice skirt, though.
Johnny. Yes. Johnny, if you could stay bald or have hair that's a perm, not a cool perm, like a perm, which would you choose? As a bald guy, I can ask you.
Okay, so could I eventually grow the perm into a...
No, yeah, it has to stay a perm.
No.
It has to stay. It has
no, I mean, can I eventually just let it all grow out into where I can have a perm ponytail? In the back, so all bushy, or do I have to just has to stay that
like
way?
It has to stay like crusty high. when he was trying to pretend when he faked his own death.
Yeah, when he was like doing the stand up. No, it has to be high and tight at the curve.
I just
for the rest
stay,
of your life. Or
I'd probably stay bald because I'm just like, you know how much money I save on shampoo. So.
Yeah, I'm with you, brother. Yeah.
The expertise of flaring orient
direct to your modern kitchen. Oh, fuck, I remember. What is this called? It's the
Orient Express bamboo. Hey, we have
the bamboo steamer. The Orient Express. Oh,
they had the Orient Express.
We have
one right now. We have one in our kitchen.
Awesome.
Yeah. You can make dumplings with them.
Yeah, you can. We don't.
The best steamer with the racist name. Orient.
Yeah. Nora loves dumplings.
Just everything you cook in it smells weird. Yeah.
Dumplings, salmon, and salad. Those are three Nora's three favorites.
Okay. That's pretty healthy.
Yeah, she will eat the salmon sashimi. Just like wolf it down.
Crazy. Someone took a shit next to that piece of corn. Oh, that corn looks good.
So everything that comes out of that smells weird. Because we have one. And we, weird.
Okay.
It tastes like it smells.
Bread.
I guess it tastes.
Why are they
smells
cooking
like
the chicken with the?
Yeah, that doesn't seem right.
Hell yeah. Oh, you get free wind chimes.
And you get, here's your. You can't cook without. Your free racist wind chimes. Shaped like the owl.
Oriental wind chimes.
And you get a bowl. One single bowl. Oh,
the Orient Express.
Here's Hirohashi with details on how to order.
To order the bamboo steamer, phone toll free 1-800-257-1233.
The Urban General, Urban National Bank in Wyckoff, New Jersey.
Just one guy in New Jersey who has to answer the phone for all of these things.
What do you want? We don't know. You can't get it.
Okay, Urban National Bank, that's some mobbed up shit.
Their last name happens to be Urban.
Yeah.
Once again, it is a rare privilege and certainly a real honor to have with me. The worldwide wrestling
fans. Oh yeah.
And here's the thing, wrestling fans. If wrestling was real, Bob Backlund would stick Ric Flair's foot right up his asshole.
He said as much to me just a few minutes ago.
We were drinking from my flask, and he told me those words.
That I don't normally drink, Gordon, but it's an honor to be with you, so I'll just have a quick hit of that. Whoa, let me tell you what happens.
Oh, jeez.
You know, that's what I need, baby.
Tommy Riches. No, but, okay, he goes, I fought the Funks, the Briscoes, the Tommy Riches. Bob Eckel just looks over like, you fucking kidding me? Tommy Rich? Okay.
Well, of course, there's one man that you have. Oh, he was a former NWA champion at this time.
Well, I heard a rumor that, you know, I heard a rumor that he let Jim Barnett blow him to get the title for that 6-day. Matches of all
time. I'm looking forward to it. You can feel the way you want to about Mr. Flair, but I know he's got a lot of ability and.
Oh,
man, but I want to beat him.
Oh, that pinstripe suit. That's pretty nice.
He's doing the work for it. It's like, I don't need the energy if I've got this. Pinstripe suit on. Do all the heavy lifting.
This gets me over.
I think you'll get a better idea of why these men are champions, and yet
now we're going to get some
as
highlights.
As is custom, I'd like to have the two of you kiss. Let's go
first and watch Ric Flair. Shake hands and give each other butterfly kisses.
Passionately, please, and slowly.
Hey, more Mike Jackson.
Oh no, I'm kind of concerned about that guy's bowl.
This is, you know, me too. Me too. Hey.
That guy has a terrible bowl.
Like I said, he's alive and wrestling today, so I think.
New jumpsuit's in. New jumpsuit's in.
Crimson. Crimson jumpsuit.
Howard Stern is the referee.
Yeah.
Robin.
Well, let me tell you something, Robin. The rip of me off.
Eric Bogosian is the referee.
Oh! You hear that guy? Really?
Yes.
That's
hear that in the rafters. So what? How many spots? What can Rick do tomorrow? What can Rick do tomorrow? Or our Sunday, pardon me, in 2 days?
He can strut. He can elbow drop. Yeah. Probably figure four.
He can woo. I'm sure he can woo.
He will definitely try to do the flip. And that's how he's going to break his neck.
Yeah,
3-1 on breaking neck. Heart attack in the middle. Heart attack in the middle is like 2-1 odds. I'm going for breaking his neck on the. I'm betting it all on does Flair flop, never gives up, never gets up. That's when the heart attack happens.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
That would be something.
They cart him out on the stretcher, face down,
like
out of respect for the
stretcher. Like that, or a gif of that recently.
To watch myself on television.
So fitting.
I have to admit, I'm really impressed. What a man.
Everybody knows it's a bad scene when they see Darren Aronofsky in the crowd.
Right, so
they won't play Backlund stuff. They won't play anything from New York, I'd imagine, right?
They probably would, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. They were still tight relatively at this time.
You don't see a whole lot of guys coming out of it, do you?
No, very frankly, I've never seen anybody.
Worldwide, when I put that on, it's I give up.
Question on that, Bob. Back
that's
on,
not true, right?
Yes. An opportunity there to see the, see that. And before we talk about it, however, why don't we go and watch you in action? And
here we go. So they had Flair showing Flair against a jobber. Who are they going to show against?
Okay.
It's me and Greg Valentine turning the house
down. The exhibition against Mr. Olymp or L Olympus.
That'd be great. No, here's him and Jesse Ventura, right?
No, I think it's Superstar Graham. This is the
Superstar Graham. Okay.
Midnight he won the title.
Okay, so well, that was a Ric Flair beating a local jobber. Here's me beating Superstar Billy Graham in the middle of Madison Square
Garden.
That's nuts. This is on the team. Oh, that's nuts.
Yeah.
That's
fantastic. Yeah.
Vince Sr. insisted on this.
Tough
matches.
27,500
people there. 27,500 people.
Yeah.
Crazy.
Yep. That was a big night. Double sellout.
Oh, look at the strength. I just sounded like Vince.
Yes, he's very, very strong. He trains real, real hard. He weighs
about
65 pounds, and I definitely had my hands full. But Vince,
fucking hot.
I mean, Gordon, when you got that many people behind you.
Oh, baby.
What the fuck are you watching?
Fans all over
the world. That's an interesting observation. The first one who's mentioned, of course, the kind of support that you do get from the fans and the fact that
that's Superstar Billy Graham is a giant man, yeah, and Bob Backlund just
picked him up like a baby.
Like a rag doll.
But then fans get behind you, cheering for you, and maybe hollering out your name.
Oh.
By golly, you reach down inside you and you come
and yet he has tiny little calves. No, his calves
when you say, by golly, I'm not getting beat. This man's going to have to do something very, very drastic to me to defeat me. I've worked too hard. I've trained too long.
I remember, like, the one thing everyone always made fun of Backlund about is he had, like, a weird walk with his butt sticking out. And then, like, read his biography. We were so poor that I was a baby and they stuck me in a crib that was too small, so my back was fucked up. So that's why I had to become an athlete. And it's like, okay.
Oh.
There we go. New champ.
Wow. Just like... Gentlemen, may I never seen
they're booing. Boo.
I admire both of you. I respect both of you. You are obviously.
Seems like the way he celebrates, it's just like another
no
win.
Question about that. May I just
he just kind of goes, all right, golly.
Greatly,
he punches the fist up in the air, man. People.
Personally,
which one of you is I will. Man? No, Bob Backlund bashing on.
I love Bob Backlund. No, I'm just like he's
the best.
He seemed very well workmanlike.
That was it. He was the all American boy. That's what they were going with.
This is the ultimate.
Act like you've been there before. That's what it was. You know what I
mean? That's right. That's what I was going to say.
The greatest teams or individuals get together. One man can walk away with all the gold and all the glory. And Bobby Backlund, you're a hell of a man, but you're not Ric Flair.
I'm Bob.
Oh,
I'm good. Well, you know what happens, Gordon. You know, Gordon and I thought backstage. We agreed that we would shake hands. I understand this is live television, but I am going to be literally putting Ric Flair's foot right up his asshole.
Before we go, I've been obsessed with this guy over here who just keeps looking at this. He's like obsessed.
He's checking out Gordon's ass. Look at the shitter on Gordon.
Who is this?
That superstar
junk inside that trunk.
Demolition acts.
I hate to see you go, Gordon, but I love to see you walk away.
I recognize the nose.
Underneath the mask, he has the face paint and the slick back hair. Just ready to come out. 5 years
the time. Nose is the best part of a wrestling mask, I think, because it's the
I know
it's the silliest part.
I like, You got like the holes. Yeah, you got to breathe.
Hey, you know, if he didn't have it right, it's always going like.
It's a hard nut to pull off.
It's like when you get into a hot tub in your bathing suit and it pops out. You don't have a nose.
Nearby the Jets. Get them all ready, Tommy, Rick, Putsky, because we're coming to the Omni. We're coming to the Omni, baby. Monday, July 5th, in Gainesville, yeah, Georgia Florida. Seems pretty hot. It must have been pretty hot at this time. I mean, obviously, oh, yeah. if they're doing this double show. I'm going to get some beer back at the O'Connell Center and all outlets. Then Saturday, July 10th, 8:30 p.m. in Huntington, West Virginia, at the Memorial Fieldhouse. Tickets available at the Fieldhouse and all outlets.
And Sunday, July 11th. Guys, I real quick little league update.
Team
didn't win a game all season. There's lots of reasons why I'm not going to get into now. But until we're in the playoffs, there's the losers bracket.
Losers tournament.
Yeah, to get into the playoffs. The team that we played is a team that we could have beaten when we played them. That we had to forfeit to because we didn't have enough kids show up. They had the same thing happen, but for the playoffs, not enough kids showed up. So we had the forfeit win. That was our first win of the season. Yes,
big one.
And, I hope all your boys were like right up in the other guy's grill, like
that's a win, baby. We, then we said,
that's
we said
one for the good guy.
No, we except said nobody was there. We said, nobody was there to yell.
The four kids.
No. We said, look, let's just play a scrimmage. We'll give you one of our kids, and let's just play and have fun. And we just put like. All of our pitchers, we put them in the outfield, and we had kids who'd never pitched before. And we're like, come on, let's see what you got, and have some fun, get you guys in the infield. And but then I also
died.
Got to, hello. I'll tell you a bit more later because this guy I'm very interested in. You tell me about.
I've been accused of several serious crimes.
If I've committed a crime to you, please call 1-800-257.
I am very likely guilty.
Oh, fuck, I remember this. I remember the guy
with
the big
letters.
I've
done a lot of crime.
Shit.
Limited
don't
benefits
worry.
First
no physical examination. If you're aged 50 to 80 and I committed a crime against you, you will not be turned down.
I'll pay you back $6.95 a month.
For the rest of my living life, which could not be long.
Basement window open. Basement window open. It was probably me. Call this number. Call for it now before
this offer comes to an end. I just love committing crime. For free information in the mail, call 800-257-1234. Oh, you calling about that asshole? Fuck that guy.
Remember,
I don't care if you're 62. I'm hanging up on you.
Okay, so perfect. Baseball. So, I also, the last thing I did was I coached one of the all-star teams because no one else was stepping up to do it. And we had the game, and luckily, at the last minute, two other coaches did, and I had Mike, one of my coaches, and I had a bunch of kids, including my nephew, who didn't need to be constantly told how to play baseball. So I got to be like a coach, and I'm the one, you know, cheering you on and giving you the pep talks and shit.
I love that picture you shared of that squad.
Yeah, and we went out there, and the game was a great fucking game. It was like, this feels so good to be coaching a real game of baseball. And it was the bottom of like the ninth.
Young Bob Duvall.
You know, and we were down two runs, and we got those two runs and celebrated, and it was fucking great.
Awesome. Yeah, I love that team picture, man.
Yeah.
Ike the Warrior. You guys ever heard of that?
Yeah,
that TV movie?
Must be
Ike the Warrior.
He looked
Warriors.
Warriors.
This one's to the.
Is this Mike time, Jackson at the end?
It is.
Time here.
Holy shit, Mike Jackson is all over this.
And Tom Pritchard.
And that has to be like something being a wrestler who's a jobber. And then in the 1982, and you're Mike Jackson, everyone's got to be like.
Should come out with one glove, man. Ladies
yeah.
Go crazy for
giving him like, ribbing him backstage. He's like, you know what you need to do? Just go out there and moonwalk.
That or beat it.
You almost got a Danny Thomas spit take, but I had to hold it in. And suddenly the
two of them say, hey, wow. Man, he talks just like the real Michael Jackson, too.
Yeah. I do imagine Dusty trying to talk him into it every day.
Ignorant.
Like, baby, Mike, you've been here forever, baby. Here's the thing.
It's your name, baby. It's your name.
Your name, baby. You know, there's a way to... I know how talented you are, baby. You're one of the best.
Say that I'm from Neverland.
I've got a dream, baby.
It's the way you talk, baby.
The American dream.
With a monkey? Should I bring a monkey?
Yeah, bring the monkey. You got a monkey?
I did not have a monkey.
It's already in your car, baby. It's already in your car. Go get that monkey.
This is gonna fulfill my dream of making a wrestler, a white guy. I want to take a white guy and make him an African American rock and roll legend.
This is a sprint to finish off the 2 hours here. I like it.
Yeah,
man, Mike is the
Mike Jackson
worker.
Could have been Johnny B. Bad. Mike Jackson could have been Johnny B. Bad,
yeah,
but he turned Dusty down.
He had to put sell a red the jacket on
him. MVP of the show.
Thus far, Mike Jackson. A submission
hold.
Oh, the timer again.
I was sort of hoping for some.
Oh, is the timer also
is,
down to the hour?
Why is the
this
timer?
Is like, yeah. How much time is left?
It's
yeah.
down to the
also.
Hour. Partial crotch ride on the or the 6:05. I remember the first time I experienced it, I'm like, why is it all on 5 minutes later? And I heard Ted Turner's idea of why. And it was like the dumbest thing. But
what is it? What's the reason?
He thought it was because if he goes 7:05, everything else that's on has already started. And you're going to want to just stay with the station, I think, or something like that. I don't know.
I always wondered that about TBS. Why
it was something
shows ended like 5 minutes later.
Don't quote me on it, but it's something like that.
Oh, I guess that's.
No, I believe it. I'm quoting you. Wikipedia.
They're calling it GCW. But oh, yeah. Well, I guess.
Oh, that is too
game changer. Yeah,
Georgia Championship.
Game changer wrestling, 1982.
Right, that's what I want to see. I want to see Effie. I want to see
self-promotion, everybody.
I want to see Effie in front of that. Oh, here we go.
September 17th, a new adventure begins.
Oh, yeah.
Live from the historic auditorium at the Commercial Drive Legion. Boom, pro wrestling explodes. Pick your jaw up off the floor and mark your calendar with Boom Pro Wrestling's first season. 9 events stretch from September through June, including I Want Candy on Halloween weekend, the Coco Harriet Women's Invitational on February 25th, our New Year's Eve Spectacular, and our season finale, the biggest one, on June 25th. But first, the action ignites on September 17th at Boom's debut event. We bought a wrestling ring. And that's a shoot, brother. Did we bite off more than we can chew? You're damn right we did. That's what happens when you make a long-distance phone call to the epicenter of quality ring construction, Lawrenceburg, Kentucky.
Kentucky born right here.
Little Raven Rings and Cages, Lawrenceburg, Kentucky. Alice speaking.
Alice, I need a 16-foot professional wrestling ring sent to Vancouver, British Columbia, stat.
Please hold.
Made from blue Kentucky steel, forged in the Appalachian Mountains, with genuine lucky Kentucky turnbuckles included with the purchase.
That's a thing.
And a funky Kentucky mat canvas made from real Kentucky Derby winners. We assume we didn't just buy a wrestling ring. We bought a shrine, a pedestal, a sacrificial altar to the regionally specific Vancouver wrestling gods. Pro Wrestling, Saturday, September 17th, live from the Commercial Drive Legion, just 2 blocks from the SkyTrain station. Come sip a $4 beer and cheer the high-flying Jackie Lee. Boo the man you love to hate, Tony Baroni. Be blown away by Evan Rivers. And making his debut, former President of the United States of America, Abraham Lincoln, takes on Harm Singh Man. As chosen by the heart Church, Duchess of Wrestling, Ravenous Randy Myers, and Golden Boy Travis Williams kick off our tournament for Boone's highest honor, the Vancouver City Championship. On the other side of the bracket, fan favorite, the silky smooth Guilford Playboy, Sharif Morrow, steps into the ring against
Travis Williams.
Returning to the squared circle. Sunscreen on his perfectly symmetrical
face. This is
you,
right? Is this your gimmick?
A man wants you to know that he's significantly more attractive than you are. Brady Malibu comes to shore. Sharif Morrow, Brady Malibu. A match so handsome, it will make you puke. And in our main event, a three-way dance between the most powerful women in the Lower Mainland, the Goblin King, Izzy McQueen, the legendary Nicole Matthews, and Commercial Dry Zone Cat Power. Did I mention $4 beers? Did I mention the ring is from Kentucky?
All right, I appreciate you letting me indulge.
Amazing.
We'll see y'all. We'll see y'all there. Well, I mean,
Bedlam, 1 hour of the most dear Lord.
Historic, if you can call it. Is the first one you've seen, Kelly?
It's going to be action packed from beginning to end.
Dying days, Indianapolis.
Are we doing a big one tonight? Yeah. How long is this? World's
champion. Another 45 minutes.
Yeah, we're in on Bruiser.
Title: Chris Carter and El Bracero, and the Russian Igor Zakov meets Rick Sampson.
I hope someday that Moose gets a hold of Wojo and sets
this is
on
even
for
lower
three
than
hours.
Vancouver's sunk in the
he wants
80s.
Moose to sit on Wojo for 3 hours.
Wojo, yeah, I know. Barney will be pissed. Wojo's going to
be far too short.
Wojo's going to be late.
Too much. Get to the kill a man.
Another edition of Bruiser Bedlam coming to you from the Fabulous Premier Center in Detroit.
I looked at the. Now what I'm doing
up
right now is there's our board. Is this Phil? Is this Genesis?
Shit. So yeah.
Late Genesis. Early Genesis is fucking awesome. Peter Gabriel was there, I love that shit. I love that artsy fucking nonsense.
What a collection of stars.
There we go.
Oh, let's just get to the point, right?
Here he is. Don't think it's the real hangman. No.
How do you know?
Last time we saw him wear the Moose helmet, he was.
Jesus Christ.
They were doing empty.
Help me out here.
They were ahead of their time.
He comes into Thriller.
What is Mike Jackson doing in the Moose Zone?
Fucking Moose Cholak.
Mike Jackson's about to jump him.
Tried to hit him. He keeps trying to hit him. I was like, I can't feel a thing. I'm wearing a goddamn moose head on top of me, you dumb fuck.
On top of his head.
Oh, Christ,
he's so goddamn hot. I hate this job. Ma'am.
At this point.
Don't touch me.
He was a sizable star at one point. 20, 30 years earlier. Good Lord.
The weird thing about the headpiece is he could actually hear through the ears.
Which is strange.
It amplified everything. I
can't believe this.
You're hearing about
Moose was deaf.
You never
that's
hear about it.
That's his hearing mechanism.
He doesn't need to hear. He doesn't need to hear to kick ass in the ring.
The poor guy has no idea why he's in the ring.
That's why he wore it on
the ring. He's got the noose already.
Uh-oh. Huh?
Moose the Moose?
Oh.
What a right hand.
You guys have had some brilliant successes over the years.
Talk about your dead, horrible territories.
Yeah, we've been here before.
But right, that's
oh,
like,
yeah.
Good job.
You haven't seen the behind-the-scenes segments there,
big
Kelly.
Big fan.
No.
I'd forgotten I'd seen his name, but like recently someone was talking about the Chicago, Kelly, the Chicago footage with Russ.
Chicago
and they're like, young Moose Cholak is all over that being the big athletic man.
Yeah, Moose Cholak is in the Way of the Blade. He's one of the top 50 bloody matches of all time.
Yeah.
He's moosing up.
We should find that, man. I wonder if there's footage of that.
One of the few ways you can get to a man like UConn Moose Cholak is through the eyes.
Moose is going to juice.
Just sad.
Look, every time we see him, there's more of that. It's been washed one more time. There's more of the letters.
It's supposed to be Moose. UConn Moose.
Smart,
he'd get out of the way. UConn Moose.
He can't afford another one. You know how expensive those things are down at the boardwalk?
The
hangman
in the corner. Totally is the, let's lose with a big right. It's the mascot costume for the couple guy that used to carry Oscar around. That guy's name Sully?
Yes, Sully the garbage man.
He was kind of nightmare material. Every once in a while, something would show up on Sesame Street that would scare the shit out of him.
See, I don't remember there being a garbage man who ever took away Oscar. Maybe I did not.
Yeah, Oscar
it,
went.
But
he was like a full-size dude. He never spoke.
Look at that mask, Bruiser. No.
Kind of looked like Lil Ambrose. You couldn't see his eyes.
Clearly, I think I remember a couple of years where I watched it every day, and there's two things I don't remember that. I remember hearing about when they finally decided to let it happen, but for me, it used to frustrate the fuck out of me that everybody thought that Snuffleupagus was imaginary.
Yeah, but I just saw the footage. Somebody just put on Twitter the day when they all meet him for the first time.
Everything's going Moose's way so far. Anyway, when I said I
wrestled him. And that's when I learned TV was lying to me.
Thank you for bringing me in from that alternate dimension I kept disappearing into. Mr. Hooper says hello.
Well done. Nice.
Snuffy is a sweetheart. Snuffy and Callie were always kind of close. Snuffy and Callie were always just both pants are full.
But I love that he called it. He called that from like.
Dude, I'm sorry. I heard some ribs crack. That was
I'm
my
sorry,
bad.
Guy.
He looks like
guy. You
very
okay,
regionally
guy.
Specific. Guy. He looks like if Johnny Gaudreau's dad let himself go.
I don't know. I guess it is Moose, but some of the letters.
Moose the normal.
There was one where we've seen episodes where it was just one of the O's was separated
from Moose after the
now they're all falling. That's not the sound a Moose makes, Moose. Relishes his victory here at
ringside. My God.
Best shape of my life.
This is
he isn't, I will say, I've seen the worst
footage I've ever seen.
Moose has been in worse shape.
It only gets better.
The hangman out of the canvas, setting him up now.
That's better.
Okay. That's one of the funniest finishes I've ever seen. That's one of the funniest finishes.
Okay, I'm gonna do the thing.
It's like the worst pin in the history of
that. I know. He's in pain.
Oh, Igor.
He's in like great Kali levels of pain.
That's like,
if you'd like to join us and see the taping of the Bruiser Bedlam television program, our next taping session is at the Premier Center at Sterling Heights, Michigan, just north of Detroit, 14 Mile and Van Dyke. Thursday, June the 12th, the action at 7:30. The one everybody's talking about right here in the Glass City of the Hotel Sofitel in downtown Toledo. What an extravaganza it's going to be. The strongest
the jersey. Don't even think about it. We do not have a jersey
operator. We have 25 fans left. It's brought to you by Miller Beer. 20 of them are
inside
talking about this match. 16-foot steel cage.
Dick the Bruiser and Calypso Jim. Miller Beer. Face
Jerry Graham. Calypso Jim.
We got the world tag team title.
You're going to see Prince Mama Mohammed against the big guy, Moose Cholak. Return battle between Chris Carter and the Polynesian Wild Man.
Pardon me, not the morbidly obese guy.
Okay, literally every character in every one of these matches is some sort of racial thing, and then a midget.
Free parking at the Vistula Garage at the corner of Jackson and Summit Streets.
Bruiser, I'm still doing the booking.
Still has not been able to obtain the special referee he wanted.
Internationally
known superstar Hillbilly Jim's cousin. Junior, you're looking very resplendent.
Cousin
today,
Junior's
nice
coming in.
A challenge for you on the 22nd.
Well, thank you. You know, Dr. Graham, besides making me an undefeated world champion,
on the left, there's a new
like
sunglasses.
A champion, and now he has me dressing like a champion,
like
thanks to
the
doctor and Jack's Men Shop, of course. But I, you know, this cousin
Jack's
Junior,
Men
I'm not worried
Shop.
About him. But it
so
is
cousin
nice
Junior. Cousin Junior,
years,
I wonder.
Putting up a challenge to all these other
Wow. Did you literally say wow? Because
dude, we saw some Cousin Junior matches when
coming
we were
to Toledo to challenge
back
me.
In the day, like about a year ago, I remember.
I'm just wondering if it's actually that Cousin Junior.
Jim's Cousin Junior's been all over the world. He's beaten a lot of top men.
Well, there was the two, right? Cousin Junior and Cousin Luke.
It was Cousin Junior and Cousin Luke. I'm just, I'm wondering, I'm worried that Cousin Luke is impersonating Cousin Junior. If we discover Cousin Junior as like the super worker of this promotion, and it's all worth it.
Does that belt actually have straps on it, or is just the plate?
Just plate.
It's just the
just
plate.
Just a commemorative plate.
There's a 1-900. There's a 1-900 ad for that.
We can give you the plate, but it'll cost you more for the straps.
Just right into Bruiser Bedlam at 151 West Jefferson for your plate.
Excellent evening
of professional wrestling at its best. Now, if you'd like to find out what the deal is, here's how to do it. Write to us in care of Bruiser Bedlam, 151 West Jefferson, Suite 514 in Detroit, 48226. Or give us a call during business hours.
Wait, that's the address they get on, I got on the internet to send my passport information.
Johnny, I got some bad news for you. You're not going to Canada.
You're not going.
Zach Koff.
Oh, why don't you go Zatkoff?
His opponent. I remember this young Rick Sampson.
Yeah, we've seen him before.
Here is Eagle. Yeah, here he is. Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, you're like a bear.
What was his music?
Well, at least he's doesn't have the shaved head. Steady improvement
from Rick Sampson. Yeah, we've seen this guy before.
Karnoff.
He also has some sort of strange entrance music.
Nice arm drag there from our boy. There we go.
There we go.
This son of a bitch around.
The great Tossin Rusky. Hey, the great Karnoff. He's got that neck. Oh, gosh, I remember that. If I'm correct,
didn't Samson wrestle? Why is he minus one? He
may have. Soviet Russia arm drags you.
Samson with a body slam. Zatkoff bails out.
Yeah, man. I'm Samson looking Zatkoff hot today. Strolling around ringside. What am I looking into what happened
yeah,
to him? I remember him being looking better he than just everybody took his shirt else. Off.
No, I remember we said that he looked okay. I remember us sort of Zatkoff going nuts for Zarkov here.
Yeah, we were fans.
Zatkoff.
Zatkoff.
Could be if he's exiled to Siberia as well.
Oh, they're gonna if he doesn't win here, he's gonna get exiled.
Samson, the collision. Oh, no, Zatkoff sidestepped it through a knee, caught Samson off guard.
It was one of my favorite 80s things that I used to just Zatkoff made me laugh like so much was every time, like, especially Ivan Kolb's like, orders from the Kremlin. We must take tag team titles. It's the greatest.
I know.
It's so stupid.
That's good, though.
The chant of USA goes up from the throng in attendance. Zatkoff doesn't like to hear that.
A whole throng.
A chant. Oh, here comes it was like USA.
Literally sevens of children.
Samson looks like he injured his.
And at least one parent.
Holding on to it. He's got a 10 count on the outside here.
Better hurry up or he's going to be counted out.
Dumb piece of shit.
Zatkoff moves.
Oh, he's got those pinstripe tights.
Stand over here. I will count. To
continue with the count. Those are some quality stairs
and globe.
Got a lot of courage trying to get back.
Yeah, I don't know. The quality for the quality for your promotion of this.
It's like the DC villain, the jailer. Remember him?
Yeah. The man rushing. Oh, look at him. He's got his throat right across the bottom. Rope standing right on him.
Classic pre-crisis villain.
Still to come in the program today, the world heavyweight champion, the great Wojo, joins us, along with the leading contenders for the tag team title, Chris Carter and El Bracero. Superman.
Our boy, Chris Carter, X-Files creator. We'll make
appearance.
X-Files and it shows the Lone Gunman and
Millennium. Millennium.
M13 production.
Yes, he is, definitely.
I always thought that was wild that a show as somewhat pretty successful as X-Files tried the spinoff. So you think, oh, that'll all work, right? Releasing his grip on Samson. And now, look at that.
Millennium is a great show. It's also
yeah, no, it
really
was
good
hot for a while.
Show
it was hot for a while.
Medicine.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
On cough medicine, it's an awesome show. If you ever get really, really sick,
one of
them
Tussins.
Yeah,
I'm a Lance show. I'm a Lance Henriksen fan.
Zach Gott just went flying. Power back some of them, some of that Tussin.
Give me some of that purple monkey magic.
Maybe it's this weird friend that we don't really hang out anymore with, and he wanted to start a bowling league with us where we all pound back Robitussin for everything. We call ourselves, the Tussins.
No, no, the no. The Tossin Tussins. You're the Tossin Tussins.
The Tossin Tussins.
Yeah.
That is a terrible and yet wonderful idea.
I know. I know.
That's once again, Samson caught
with that boot. One of those dudes. That's one of those dudes that you're younger Zach with, and you kind of realize.
Sure.
You hang out with this guy.
I would never do that. Even in my young days of doing dumb shit, I would never like. 10 years later, I'd be like, hey, let's drop acid and bowl. But I would never fucking.
I used to. I'm sure I've told this story before, but I used to snort beer. Luckily for Samson, I don't know. And I used to talk people into snorting beer, and it was awesome. It was super good for a while.
We know it's something we can do on October 29th.
And then starting gears, I can't do it anymore. No. It's a terrible thing.
We're going for sushi.
Do.
Johnny's going to have some of Nora's favorite sashimi.
Oh, yeah, well, does that sushi. So. Can I bring a hamburger to the sushi place?
Yeah. and Johnny refuses to try a Caesar, Kelly.
Yeah,
gotta
yeah.
Try
he
Caesar.
Won't drink a Caesar.
Johnny, you gotta try.
I don't like. I don't like tomato juice. I've never had a Bloody Mary. I'm not gonna have a Caesar. I don't like tomato juice.
Come on, as a letter, Kenny and Shorzy fan, you owe it.
Okay. So by that, okay.
You
so,
should have a sip.
So I'm a Breaking Bad fan. Does that mean if I
you have to try meth? Yep.
Try meth too.
Yes, you do. Yeah, okay. That's the rule.
Only seen 5 or 6 episodes.
Sweet Vancouver.
I've tried it several times. I'm on it right now.
If you're a fan, a true fan. Things don't look too good for him at this point,
but this shows you. What was this finish? Science can
do. He I missed goes it. Right over the
top. Looks like almost every move. After the show, I'm willing to
Zach
try a pale ale. Something like that. Nice,
wow, man. We got to give you you got to have a Caesar. The young man from Dayton, Ohio. Caesar or sushi. Either one while you're in Vancouver.
I don't eat sushi. And
but there's lots of like stuff. You don't have to have fish.
Yeah, you can have other things.
Okay, what's... Bruiser Bedlam
at its best. Chicken. You can have some chicken.
Have you got chicken? That's fine. As the Miller Country Store and all shed locations. Oh, you're just gonna, you're gonna say it's chicken.
Just a chicken.
Chicken in the sea. It's tuna. It's chicken in the sea. He's an American.
Avocado. It's healthy.
Yeah. The belts, the reputations. Everything.
I'll have a Caesar salad. June 22nd at the Hotel Sofitel.
Also, you will see international star Hillbilly Jim's cousin. All of our friends from who just were, who I got to face off against the world heavyweight champion, the Great Wojo. That title belt also at stake. Happy to be here. Mama Mohammed
meeting Yukon Moose Cholak. It is one of Canada's greatest inventions. Yep.
Against Little John with the boxing gloves on and with special guest referee from Miller
Little
Beer
John.
Metropolitan Distributing Sam Botek Jr.
Yeah!
High-flying Supermax El Cicero on the opener meets the Lebanese freedom fighter Mohammed Jihad Saad.
Mohammed Jihad
Saad. Lebanese freedom fighter Mohammed Jihad Saad. Every single one of these is full of
very sensitively. They came up with that name. A major part of this card. There's our
American guy.
Watch him do Hogan. Kelly. Chris Carter against the television
wild man. It's all American Chris Carter. He's their Hogan.
Well, you know, Terry, first off, I'd like to say, you know, what an extravaganza this is on the 22nd here at the Hotel Sofitel. You know, thanks to Miller Beer being behind it, this is going to be the biggest wrestling extravaganza in the history of Toledo. You know, I'm getting back to the Polynesian.
Thank
you,
Miller.
History of Toledo.
Long, storied history of Toledo wrestling.
Not Miller's. Miller. I got the people,
baby. Right behind. He's got a bad teenage mustache.
Terry, there's no way
Super
he's going down
the best he could do
right in the middle of the ring, baby, and I guarantee it. to all my fans in Toledo, because I love each and every one of you, and God bless you all.
Certainly a man to believe in. The Spirit of America, Chris Carter, back here in your second home city against Toledo, Ohio.
Out of the shirt.
At the Hotel Sofitel, what a lineup of stars.
So cold in here.
The main event fans inside of the 16-foot steel cage, Graham and Ken against the Bruiser and Calypso Jim.
Oh, it's cold.
These backstage segments, Kelly, on the set of Three's Company. Like,
a professional wrestling in the world. It's like if you were to, spin the rack of sunglasses at a drugstore. Everybody just goes into a drugstore. Commentating
professional wrestling. This guy is he does like a million different things. He calls himself Dr. Jerry Graham. To have you as
part of the Bruiser Bedlam. And, not even junior,
He does an amazing Roddy Piper impression.
He's the star of SCTV, Rick Moranis, here with us.
So many people tell me, they say, Dr. Graham, this Terry Sullivan, why do they have to stick him with a moron like Dick the Bruiser? I mean, this man is immaculate.
He's definitely trying to do Piper.
He's trying to do Piper. That's what he's doing.
Nobody more able to correctly identify what's going on.
He's the Piper. He's the Piper and the guy who looks like he works on the auto assembly line and wrestles on the weekends is the Hogan.
He spent a lot of time in post-secondary education.
And his second favorite role look at the team. Dude, look at those degrees.
Like it's all University of Phoenix. It's all DeFry.
Barbizon. Barbizon Beauty College.
Now, you have seen, at one time or another, all the major wrestlers in the world today, say for the last 10, 15
years.
That's a fair statement. At least 90% of them.
McDonald's hamburger eating contest.
Dr. Jerry Graham Jr., without a doubt,
the greatest fighter he's
ever seen in his entire career.
Well, you want me to tell you the truth?
You have been dishonored.
These guys look like that. I feel like they're Shoot Brothers.
I mean, I think you're such a great commentator. I mean, you're the best commentator I've ever heard. Now, tell the people who
the best
is Dr. Jerry Graham the greatest wrestler you've ever seen.
Thanks for putting me over,
Dr. Jerry Graham is without a doubt the most controversial wrestler I've ever seen.
Well, but controversial isn't great. I mean, isn't Dr. Jerry Graham the greatest wrestler you've ever seen?
Oh, no, he thinks of himself as the Mike Wallace of wrestling.
Most hated wrestler.
I'm trying to be nice to you, Sullivan. I mean, I'm trying
I
to
kind of look like Roddy Piper, and this is my doctor's office.
In fact, I think you're a second-rate bum. In fact, if I wasn't so busy beating all these other wrestlers, I might just take your job and show these people what a real commentator is, and I wouldn't need Dick the Loser to tell me about wrestling because I know wrestling, and I don't have to stand here and be abused by an obnoxious, rude guest who I was nice enough to put on a show, and you start acting like that.
You're a rude, thoughtless little pig.
Well, wow. Apparently that's it for this edition of Graham's Gallery, ladies and gentlemen. I think I was more or less set up.
Well, like
Graham's Gallery.
Graham, that's the best name they could
no
come up
with. No doubt Dr. Jerry Graham will be
with Jerry Graham. Literally ripping off an
one of
actual
the all-time favorite
band.
Wrestling greats from the Motor City, Detroit.
Let's go, that let's go back to the studio and me.
In our classic let's match. Leave my house and go back.
Look at that background.
This one fall match has a 20-minute time
Tatooine.
Limit.
Oh, here's a classic.
They drew a crowd. What the fuck?
This is from the 70s.
Okay.
Yeah, this
Sister
is
Sister Saki. Oh, look at this guy. I love it. I graduated. He just graduated
in Indianapolis. I've noticed. Manson.
Mark Manson.
Oh, this guy. Oh, so he's a hippie who's smarter than everybody. And he's doing a Charlie Manson gimmick. That's dope. That's what he's doing. He's Mark Manson.
Louis Martinez.
Well, here we go. The one-four match. Louis Martinez, a sensational wrestler.
What year in the 70s? Excuse me.
Manager there.
I am all about this.
I would say mid-75, 74.
I am all about... I knew they existed, but all of the... Like, of course there were fucking evil hippies and Manson fucking characters in wrestling, but we just don't know about them. This guy. Cactus Jack. Time traveling Cactus Jack.
Well, even time Seth traveling Rollins girl, is doing it now. I'm gonna sit around the curtain. Oh well, hello. Been a long day here on MTG
It's quantum. Where Mick Foley is Sam, and the girl of Monsoon is the hologram.
Yeah, and he's just taking him to. We don't have to be here.
Have you checked out her shoes?
What do we have to do here, girl?
You don't have to be here, man.
We're attached at the hip.
I mean, you can watch. You can watch the gorilla get his rocks
off. He jumps up on the apron of the ring. He's in the ring. And he's after Saki. Crashes him.
The built-in knee pads in his tights there. That's cute.
Yeah, Mr. Fuji wore the same sort of thing in the 70s.
Okay, so what year is this from again?
74, 75, thereabouts.
And it's the same, it's the same area?
Yeah, it's Indianapolis.
This is smoking hot, dude.
Yeah, looks like
this
it,
is
right?
good.
Yeah,
it's this crazy. Is good.
Yeah, no, there's, if you look on YouTube, you'll find some more footage
that
from
looks
this
like
era.
Bulldog
with, like,
Bob
Heenan
Brown.
And the Blackjacks and stuff.
This motherfucking ref can't even tuck in his shirt. He's a fucking bum.
Who got away as a...
Looks like that. Yeah, that's a bulldog.
Side of the head, another
ooh,
one.
Joe Besser dancing around over here. Stop hitting him, you crazy.
Saki continues the chopping to the side of the head. But the very tough Louis Martinez is getting up. He is on his feet now.
Later, it's getting hotter.
Staggered a bit. Uh-oh. Double chop.
Ooh.
And Martinez is on the outside.
You notice tradition here is racial gimmicks.
As a kick,
as is the Indianapolis way.
Saki keeps chopping him.
I think the Bears are going, there's one thing we're never going to give up. Here we go. You think you're so smart, you fucking long-haired hippie freak? Manny Poffo, dude, Manny Poffo ripped that guy's gimmick off.
Right, right. Yeah, he's a genius. I saw that.
Yeah. Three count.
Surprise roll. I like how
That was a fast count, motherfucker.
There's no long matches in Cruiser, at least not today.
Boom.
Well, they're long in a way.
A very specific way.
That was maybe the best match we've seen tonight.
Oh, this was the best thing we've seen all night. Oh, Mark Manson. Come on. I'm all about Mark Manson.
Yeah,
I'm all about Maniac or whatever Mark Manson. This guy's the best.
Great victory for Louis Martinez.
This is my new favorite wrestler.
There's your Halloween costume.
He's clearly doing a hippie Charlie Manson.
Oh, no.
Sonny Pride.
Two
great proud men. Two great proud men.
Look at this.
I want you to put on the bottom. Two great proud men. You underline it in red.
We'll put them right inside of your high school, armory, civic center, whatever. All the top stocks you see here on television. Great way to raise funds.
Whatever happens, there has to be a top.
Bruiser Bedlam, 151 West Jefferson, Suite 514 in Detroit, 48226. Or call us at area code 313-567-4444.
That's
we're
four
on our way.
That's too many fours to call.
A great Wojo.
Cat, my first cat. Same birthday as me. 2 years
ago. So who's the lady in the dress?
Let's hear it for Sunny.
She's,
I know, I keep seeing her. Like,
she just stands on the apron for each match.
And the never. Champion from Toledo, Ohio, weighing in at 268 pounds. Here's the WWA Heavyweight Champion, the great Rojo.
Oh, of course, the great Rojo.
Yeah, we remember him.
Oh,
yeah.
Yeah, he was married to Dick the Bruiser's daughter. So he has not been able to get heavy for the during the dying days of the tour.
Dr. Jerry Graham at the bottom of the screen,
looking on here. I don't think he worked
and
anywhere
else. And he was also
else,
like
know.
A golden boy.
Jerry
Graham
feels he's on top of the world. I'm sure after what he did some time back there, spray painting Calypso Jim. Calypso Jim.
It's a new move.
I know, I was thinking of Gypsy Mojo Joe for a second. I'm getting confused.
Yeah. Mojo's always full of there's surprise. A Gypsy
new
Jim
buddy.
Promotion.
Oh, really?
They're related. They're totally related.
I can't wait to see a low rent version of Gypsy Joe.
The champion scoops his man up.
Look at the welts on the back.
Amazing.
Drops him down, throat first, right into the turnbuckle.
You could do a bit. You could do a gimmick where you're Gypsy Joe going back in time.
Dr. Jerry Graham
just,
pushing his
it's just
again,
an old
Bruiser.
Guy who gets the shit beat out of him. That's your
or
gimmick.
No, you're a young guy who's learned. Voice you hear you've gone back in time and now you're a young guy. I'm thinking like a switching places kind of thing.
Okay, okay.
And Gypsy Joe has to become the old man who gets the shit kicked out of him.
I don't think you use the term Gypsy Joe anymore, though.
I probably don't.
Great Wojo, very impressive here, the World Heavyweight Wrestling Champion.
There's none tougher. Oh, big suplex. Matt just jars the whole body in for the count. Oh, did he kick out? I believe he did.
Yeah.
Well, we give him some credit here. Sonny Pride.
I don't know whether he kicked out or was garbage.
I thought Sonny Pride was pure shit.
It was, dude, I was willing to bet Sonny Pride was going to be African American and just. Yeah, be a militant. Be a militant.
Mojo.
That's what I told you. Told him to pick him up.
Mojo laid in a big forearm on Sonny Pride.
Okay, so the Great Mojo's gimmick is that he's an Olympic wrestler, but he's got an Asian gimmick name or Polish.
On the middle rope, coming down.
Polish.
Yeah, but he looks
Graham totally did the suplex him again.
Well, we're seeing quite a variety
their
of suplexes
character,
from.
Like I think that my cat
the
was named
this
after.
Week. Now this may be a
Barney Miller character.
Mojo. Mojo's like the second. Yep, he's like right. The second most important character on the chair. Suplex.
It's supposed to be the Olympic rings on his boots, but it looks really.
Yeah. His time. The guy has been beaten for quite some time.
He briefly was on the Olympic tryout team, and they let him go when he insisted on being called the Great Mojo.
And Mojo once again refusing to pin the man. Another example of
this is what cost him the gold medal in the Olympics.
He had his own music he wanted to play that wasn't the Polish national anthem.
They frown on that at the Olympics. They do not like that.
Knocked him stiff that time.
Hey, look, if ice dancing can be a gold medal thing, then so can a professional wrestling exhibition. I'm not kidding.
Sure. I know what you mean.
I'm kidding. You get your Will Ospreys and them in there, and not to do something. Just enough to grab the audience for the theatrics that they like for that and do their fucking moves and give them fucking gold medals. If ice dancing is a sport, then let these bunch of spot monkeys go out and do a bunch of shit.
Well, it's going to take a lot of signature behind it. You could try.
They get 4 minutes, just like an ice dancing routine. They got to put something together.
Gotta be a sprint. That's funny.
Yeah.
Then it'll take a lot of signatures for sure.
I think the referee
always with a finish. They have to finish 1, 2, 3 just as the time runs out or some shit.
Sonny Pride was beaten some time ago.
Oh, whoa, Joe.
The Canadian team is going to fucking be hard to beat, I would imagine.
Japanese team would be tough.
I think that was a good move.
The Japanese women's team. Because of the theatrics, the Japanese women's team is going to be a gold medal fucking monster.
Yeah.
I'm sorry. Except for all the races.
It's obvious this poor guy can't take a whole lot more here. Graham. This is typical.
The longest poor guy.
Jerry Graham, once the man has been beaten to such a stage.
Is he going to try to save this young man?
The onslaught.
Where's Cousin Junior? Come on, you're probably.
Now what's he doing? Graham is going to the top rope.
Oh, this is, they're really still doing anything. Dick Graham,
leading to the big angle of Dick's coming out of retirement.
Yeah, he's not allowed to. He's not allowed to.
Have we ever seen him, come out of retirement?
Yeah, we're watching these out of order. He eventually, snaps and.
I don't think this poor guy's done yet.
We saw him have that match against Bob Orton.
Right.
Right in front of
the it wasn't from
Dick the Bruiser and Graham.
Right in the gym, man.
Is just asking
it's not
for
fun.
I was thinking about it. I like how he grits his teeth.
How can he take
it? The gym man's hurt.
That can be you down there. Isn't that what we call indicating? I'm angry.
Certainly, I think the scene would be quite a lot different if it were Dick the Bruiser there instead of Sonny Pride.
Well, Rick Moranis just does everything.
Yeah.
I'm surprised he doesn't run the camera. Like you don't.
They make the way out.
The wild eyes.
That referee looks like he's been around.
I might have mentioned that I thought he owned the promotion or something because he's all over everything.
Has his reverse chin lock.
Doctor's gonna help him again.
Andy Samberg getting the shit beat out of
him. Either that or the guy literally does the weather on whatever UHF station
that in
Indianapolis. I love you. I can't quit you.
Tag team match coming up, man.
Stay with us.
Burger and
Godfather.
Oh, Godfather.
You can't refuse.
Godfather. Oh, is he gonna be a mob guy?
On the whole train.
K.O. King Burger.
No, he's gonna come out stroking a cat and going.
Here is K.O. King Burger.
King Burger. Finally. I remember King Burger. He's the K.O. King.
Drop.
Wow.
Oh, look at this.
Who?
The Painmaker, Chris Jericho.
Who?
And their opponents.
Wow.
He's got a hearing aid.
Like the announcing's echoing through this empty room.
There he is. Chris Carter. He's the Hulk Hogan.
Which one?
Oh, boy. He comes from a different country. You're right.
El Prospero.
That wasn't even his hat. He just like he grabbed it from somebody in the crowd.
Yeah, something tells me, hey man, something tells me you don't understand the meaning of this song.
K.O. King Burger, along with the Godfather, the guy in the blue on the right of your screen there.
The Godfather.
The Godfather is the guy in the blue.
Oh yeah, no, he had a gangster hat. That hat was supposed to be a gangster hat.
Oh, he's like a 1950s gangster.
Yeah, yeah, he's like, yeah. I'm going to make him an offer.
I haven't even seen The Godfather.
Oh my God.
I assume this is what he looks like.
That's the guy from, that's the chief from Hill Street Blues.
I haven't seen any still photos from it. I have no idea. Just know it was a popular movie.
I assume he's just like a father of God. Right?
That's what it was.
No, so, that's
father. A movie about a priest.
I'm gonna fantasy book that's the actor who played Luca Brasi, was a mob guy and was a wrestler.
Was a wrestler.
But he was the zebra kid for a long, long, long time.
That's my.
And so he's taking advantage of this. He's taking advantage of this as the Godfather with his shabby fucking gangster.
That's my all-time favorite line from the Godfather is from Luca Brasi, and it is.
Might I say, Terry, that
that's the best line in Godfather.
We've got the airplane spin on Burger now by Bracero. He heads off to the Spirit of America, Chris Carter.
Chris Carter.
The Spirit of America.
These guys.
Chris Carter.
The heartbeat of America, Chris Carter.
Debbie Trucks, Chris Carter.
Down goes Burger.
Stink. Chris Carter
moves right into his man tag off to Bracero. They'll take advantage of the count here.
This is an
interesting run. Yeah.
Right into the midsection. Forearm uppercut sends Burger sprawling along the ropes.
Hey, Burger.
Bracero just threw his man right into the Godfather's a go-ahead tag.
The Godfather.
Got a King Burger with cheese.
Looks like he's spent a considerable time
onion rings
hoisted some weights.
Hoisted some weights.
Look at that spot. That's pretty great, actually.
Referee to two.
Who's this guy?
Well,
I think we've seen him before in the black.
El Bracero.
El Bracero.
That's cool. That's really cool.
I have no idea.
What do you call that, Terry?
I've never seen anything like that before.
I don't know, but it looks like he's getting aroused.
Oh, that's what it was.
No, I'm not sure.
Back of the nuts, huh?
Good. Yeah, sure. It
that's
like
the thing about Bracero, though, you know. Called he's got the so taint, many unique dick. Moves, and not only does it befuddle us,
they call it the twoat.
But it also befuddles
the twoat.
All of his opponents.
Right. Man, you guinea son of a.
How do you prepare for a match with Bracero?
I wouldn't know, but it sounded good.
Chris Carter in with a Godfather.
Yeah, Chris Carter. He's like, I don't care how many of you guinea grease balls.
Oh,
he was beautiful. She was. She was the greatest piece of ass I've ever had, and I've had him all over the world.
America's own. The voice of America.
Supermax. He's asking Chris to set him up just a little bit here.
Apple pie.
Bracero. Think.
When you think about truck nuts, think about Chris Carter.
And he hurls him off the road.
Got him. Good
one. Really shitty gun control law. Good man. Chris Carter.
Do you have the best you can possibly have in pocket fishing reels? Chris Carter here.
This is the second time we've seen him do this. Let his opponent go over and make the tag. Bring him over. He's got that Boston grab applied now.
He was dapping.
The referee asking Berger if he wants to submit. So far, no.
Berger, if he'd like fries with that.
Cerro makes the tag.
Kick him in the balls.
I think Carter might take over. Oh,
for I got it. This is got it. Can you feel me? Can you feel me behind you? Oh,
yeah.
Right.
Now that is tag team.
What the fuck is happening?
I saw this in a book called The Comics.
Side by side. It's the American way.
Cooperation.
Not close-minded. Not close-minded.
Yeah. Okay? Okay.
Not close-minded in different types of relationships. Chris Carter.
No.
The 80s, baby.
Equal opportunity, man.
The surprisingly cool guy at the key party. There's Carter. Mr.
Scientific. He's also got that incredible
debut of aspartame. Won him a lot of matches. Chris Carter.
He applies it in a very unique fashion. And very, wonder, very effective for
myself. Wonder
hasn't put it on. Fixing up a Trans Am. Chris Carter.
Uh-oh. The Godfather going to the eyes of Chris Carter. That stopped him in his tracks. Now Bracero moves in.
Form Scientologist. Yeah, that's Chris Carter.
Now Carter, a little payback.
Well, these guys are well conditioned.
Oh, teams. If you guys get a chance, watch the movie Red Rocket.
What's it called?
Chris Carter.
Red Rocket.
Godfather okay. All the way across the
it's kind of like Uncut Gems.
Oh, okay.
But it's about a porn star.
Carter in for the count now. Referee is it's, right there.
You got me at porn star.
Well, yeah.
You had me at porn stars and uncut. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, yeah. Uncut porn star? Wait, hey, get out of my fucking tabs.
Uncut porn stars?
I just like them before the directors cut them, you know, for talking back.
Oh, sure. Oh, yes. Oh, that part, you mean the outtakes. I thought you meant the...
I like them fresh.
Our good guys are a lot smaller than these.
Oh, here we go.
Tough looking guys.
Oh, give me that. Give me that. Let's go.
Some more homoerotic action coming up.
Let's see how smart I am. Well, let's
see what Chris Carter adds to this.
That sort of looks like the surfboard to me.
He's going to bring him over. This guy's. He's teasing it. He's gonna do it.
Smurf.
He's Godfather Smurf. He's Dago Smurf.
The early years.
Hey, Papa Smurf, why don't we go fuck Gargamelo? Aren't you a fucking wizard? Let's go fuck that motherfucker up.
The Smurf and told you.
There's literally 100 of us.
Never.
There's literally 100 of us.
Godfather has not an offensive move.
There's a sleeper
hole.
Bracero.
This is it.
He's got it. And I think it's
now I'm just picturing a red hat on this guy.
Yeah.
Quiet, I think quiet. This is gotta be it.
Putting people to sleep against
this is like Carlo. This is like Carlo getting it in the fucking car.
You're the devil sea sleepies. All right.
Yeah, we in.
Another immigrant dead. Chris Carter.
Someone watch actually took the time to make a sign. God bless him.
Oh, he's helping. He's helping. Oh, that's nice. Oh, no.
Yeah, what do you think about that?
The winners from the sleeper hold, Chris Carter and El Bracero.
Hail Satan.
Now we're going
to
talk
putting people to sleep and then waking them up again. Chris
Carter and El Bracero, beyond any shadow of a doubt, the leading contenders for the World Tag Team Wrestling Championship right here. What an excellent
I don't remember
match.
Him wearing a singlet
you know, Terry,
like that, though.
We are, you know,
he
I don't
always
want to
has.
Brag about it, but we are the number
just,
one contender.
He has to. This guy has to.
Championship.
America.
There's nothing more that I want. What I want to do is I want to get those tag teams.
I mean, really, if you think about it, if you're dealing with the Midwest and the auto layoffs of everything going on in the 80s, that guy is the All-American, you know, for this area. I mean, he looks just like him.
Be able to handle the World Tag Team Championship.
They're not good enough.
Maybe next time you know what?
There was an uncut. But we anytime. Right here, they shot him, but they've never been released. Like scenes from Roger and Me, where he's interviewing Chris Carter as the hero of Flint, Michigan.
Oh, no.
Yep.
Is there really? That's for real?
Yes.
Wow.
Saw a little too much of the Godfather than we wanted.
It's a Bruce Springsteen ripoff music here.
Ladies and gentlemen, a literal cavalcade of stars as Bruiser Bedlam returns to Toledo
literal.
In grand style at the Hotel Sofitel, Sunday, June the 22nd.
So the promotion at this time is called Bruiser Bedlam?
Yep.
In the Vistula Garage at Summit and Jackson,
we want to urge you to get your tickets.
Yeah.
Tickets available at the Miller Country Store on Summit Street.
That's where the
Hotel Sofitel is. Been there.
All shed locations.
Cornet when the guy, it was Johnny K-9. At 8 o'clock. And when Johnny K-9 went to Smoky Mountain, Cornette gave him the name Bruiser Bedlam because the one thing he liked about this promotion was the name. Thinking that was a good name for a wrestler. Not a good name for a promotion.
No, it isn't.
And yet here we are.
Leaders.
Here we are.
I guess that's all he had left.
The Great Wojo puts his world heavyweight championship on the line against international star Hillbilly Jim's cousin, Junior. You will see Moose Cholak meeting Prince Mama Mohammed, the
Hillbilly Jim's
man
in
a return grudge battle to meet.
Yeah, he just said Hillbilly Jim's cousin.
Got Hillbilly Jim's cousin.
Hulk Hogan's cousin.
Chris cousin.
Everyone knows Roddy Piper with
the
Dr. Jerry Graham
Freedom Fighter. The Lebanese Freedom Fighters.
That's an awesome
flag.
I'm Gene Okerlund's cousin.
He's the only guy who showed up that day.
I can't word of that. I can't.
English. You talk in English?
Shut up!
Oof.
He understands that.
This guy's got to be in his bonnet.
That's super you.
So I give him his falafel, and then he tries to return it after he ate half of it. This motherfucker, I watch him outside my outside the restaurant. He's begging for a goddamn living.
Well, consider the source and join us Sunday, June 22nd.
Hotel. Consider the source. What is he? He's Alec Baldwin.
Yeah. Well, I told you.
I'm
going to open and close. That's what
and
I do.
Here's Vince McMahon's
Something to go to bed to. You
keep putting together better and better cards every week.
So what's going to haunt you more, James? Stan Hansen or that?
Well, Dick the Bruiser does look like my nutsack.
We are fucking... We literally bruise Friday. We are back on Friday in 2 weeks. With Peter Winston. Really excited. Kelly's put together a really good playlist for that show. Peter's awesome. I can't wait for us to hang out with him.
This has been a presentation of
James,
Bedlam Productions Incorporated in association with Championship
Wrestling Incorporated.
Figure out how to
get to Vancouver late October.
Yeah.
We'll make it happen. Thanks for putting up with that bitch in the middle there, guys. Tickets available if you're in the Vancouver area.
Putting up with? Don't fucking... Don't run.
What's that?
I said thanks for putting up with that bit in the middle.
Oh, yeah, no, you know what I mean.
No,
I don't know.
I'm feigning humility. That's what that is.
Don't. This is wrestling. That's why, you know.
Thanks again, everybody.
I'm going to go over there and take over that goddamn promotion. I'm going to invade from down fucking here.
God bless Dick the Bruiser.